Sports Talk. David Kieber along with Terry Reinhart, Jason Barber, Kevin Hastings, and Evan Smoke Ludwig on the control board this morning. Has been having fun already this morning leading up to the show. If only the next 2 hours are as fun as the previous 10 minutes.
It's all right.
At Terry's expense,
our low cut, our low cut Cowboys are on the way to the Super Bowl.
Low cut,
OSTT, off season trash talker. Man, got plenty to talk about this morning in the world of sports. A lot of high school tournaments wrapping up this week. Some teams, some conferences didn't have tournaments. Regular seasons wound down. Kevin and Smoke had a had two games plus an inning. A couple nights ago, a long 15-inning game they attended and broadcast for you between Crest and Burns. We'll talk about that a little bit. East Lincoln Bunker Hill met last night. West Lincoln and Bunker Hill met for the softball conference title last night. Lots going on. Last weekend, you know, we talked about, I guess, one of the best things to happen this week for me was Deflategate resurfaced because it took all the airwaves away from that fight that I actually wound up caring nothing about and didn't want to hear.
It was more of a dance contest.
Yeah, right. Kevin said he should have won Dancing with the Stars, but glad to see that kind of faded away when Deflategate resurfaced. That was, you know, I didn't want to hear that either, but it was better than hearing about the boxing match.
I'm just glad. It's so funny to sit back and watch people that, I guess, that what didn't know a Floyd Mayweather fight, and they get all upset and get mad. Like, what did you?
Well, you know what, though, Jason? I bet 75% of the people that watched that fight that night probably never seen him before.
That's true,
dude. Yeah, I'm about to say, but that's Floyd's style.
Because
that's why people got
so
mad.
Much.
That was funny, man. That was funny. I was sitting watching.
I think with the people getting mad, it just shows you how far boxing has fell off in the past 15 to 20 years.
Well, it's hard to explain to anybody younger than 40 or that's never seen Floyd how the guy who dodged the most punches is the winner, not the one, you know, not the aggressor in the fight.
But also, but the job is to hit and not get hit, and he's great at not getting hit.
Yeah.
And Manny Pacquiao after the fight, well, you know, he wouldn't stay still.
That's true. But there's no place on the scorecard where you go, well, he didn't get hit on that swing.
Yeah, but my whole deal in behind the fight, I mean, 148 punches to 81. So, I mean, it was kind of hard for anybody to say he did not win. Then there's people up after the fight saying Pacquiao would win. How? How could he win and he only got 81 punches in?
Well, I'm not saying he could have won. It was just for a fight. Just you couldn't call it a fight, first of all, the way between Floyd's the way he does and then Pacquiao's wasn't as aggressive he was. Apparently because of this left arm injury.
Yeah, supposedly.
Yeah,
and now the boxing world's mad at him for not bringing that out.
That's true.
He's got people suing
him. If I put money on Pacquiao, I mean, think about it. If you really think he was going to win that fight and put a lot of money on it, wouldn't you be really mad right now?
Or if you just put the money down to watch it.
Or, yeah, that too.
You know, I mean, and you guys watched it, Jason?
Yeah. I did. But
and Kevin?
I went to the fight
point. I didn't pay a dime for it.
I mean,
you didn't either. Smoke?
I watched something better, Game 7 of
it was awesome.
Spurs.
That
Clippers.
Was one of the best basketball games.
Yeah, that happened. That would happen before
right
the fight.
Before.
So yeah, it's about time to fight so. Game
yeah,
in
that would,
the fight
yeah,
started.
After watching that, the fight would have been very disappointing.
Yeah,
very disappointing.
Yeah. I mean, that was one of the best basketball games I've ever seen, and I was totally pulling for the Spurs in that game. And Chris Paul, he just, I've always thought he was way overrated. But in that game, in those last two games in that series, I mean, he just
showed
went
what
off.
He can
I mean,
do.
He just really did. And I'm not saying he pushed off on Danny Green on that last play, but it looked like kind of like LeBron going to the lane. But he hit an amazing shot over Duncan too,
yeah.
So you can't take that away from him at all. But it was one of the best games I've ever seen.
Smoke, you was probably happy last night. Reddick and Rivers had, what did they score, 50-some points combined?
Yeah, they both went off. I mean, Austin Rivers in the playoffs, we saw a little bit of it in the San Antonio series. I've never seen Austin Rivers play this good in the NBA, maybe even ever. It's kind of weird seeing that, and J.J. Redick's going back to his old self in college. So Duke Star's looking real good in NBA playoffs right now.
I wouldn't say he's going back to his old self in college because actually in the
Terry?
Pros, he can drive to the basket now.
Look at Terry. How's your Celtics doing, Terry?
That's all right. All I got to say is if the Clippers make the championship This is all set up.
Well, it'll be between them and Golden State.
Why is it set up?
I'll tell you what.
The Clippers went through in the past year, 2 years, 3 years of everything that's happened out there, and then now make the championship, something's not right.
They're clearly better than Houston, though.
Yeah, they are. I think overall player for player.
I don't know if Houston can beat them another game.
I mean, I think James Harden's defense might have something to do with Rivers already going off.
Yeah, I mean.
Seems to be his man always scores quite a bit of points. But a big win for the Clippers last night, 124-99 over Houston. And then the game last night had to be Chicago beating Cleveland, the last-second shot by Derrick Rose that banked in. But you know what? It was a desperation shot from behind the three, probably about 6 feet behind the three-point line.
We talked about that.
And you'll take a bank.
That was the basketball gods getting back for not calling the foul.
That's exactly right. If they think he did not foul him, there's a problem.
Terry, you not a LeBron fan?
Huh? Oh, I like LeBron. Okay. I think he's the best player in the NBA, but that was a foul. Yeah. I mean, come on.
I don't know. Honestly, I think he thought Chicago was going to call a timeout. So if you're going to just take that gamble right before a timeout is called.
You know what I thought? I thought he was thinking about that they were down. No, not down. That they had a foul to give, and that he could just go foul him so he didn't get the shot off, and they had to reset. Mm-hmm. Any of those theories could be right. Either way, it was a foul, wasn't it?
It was a foul.
But you can't blame him.
No, you can't blame him.
He don't wear the whistle, and he wasn't making the call. And you know what? It's one of those times where I hate to see referees do this, but if he actually got the ball and got control of it, you might have heard the whistle blow.
Mm-hmm.
Since it didn't change anything, you know, it makes you wonder. It did change a little
bit. Could change the series.
He left him with having to inbound the ball instead.
But what if Rose misses that shot, then the next play, and then in overtime, LeBron wins by 10?
But you know, and you might have been right, because after the thing, you see LeBron looking up to see how much time is left. So maybe he did think he had a foul to give.
I don't know.
But, you know – I mean, you said you thought Chicago might call a timeout, or he was thinking they might call a timeout. Would you call a timeout in that situation?
Well, I thought maybe they'd get the ball past half court. Maybe they had a timeout. Yeah. But hey,
most time you just call it on
as soon as the basket's made so they can advance the ball anyway. So.
And when did the rule change? It's probably been 10 years, you guys tell me, where you get it three-quarter court now.
It's been a rule now for a good 10 to 12 years.
Under 2 minutes, as soon as the ball goes in, you can call timeout and advance.
As long as
you don't take a dribble.
Free throw extended, right? Yeah. That's about where you get it. Yeah. Or
supposed to be about half court, circle. But it's a little
bit further
that,
now.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's further now.
As long as you, the other team missed the ball, you rebound it. As long as you don't take a dribble, you call timeout, you can advance it to the front court.
But if you take a dribble,
then
it's got to come back
where you are.
Yes.
Okay. I was just wondering, because the game that made it that really stood out
college
to me
don't do that.
Was no, no, thank goodness. I don't like it really.
I mean, I like it because it sets up more drama.
That's the only reason though. Yeah, but I mean, it's kind of unfair to the team that just scored to take that lead and you don't have to dribble the ball down the floor. But the game that stood out to me, I think, is that Clippers game we were talking about last Saturday, where they were able to line up and throw a lob.
Yep.
And I think it's Matt Barnes that knocked it away.
Yeah, he was actually on the backside defense.
Played good.
With the Spurs. Right. But, you know, there was a clock controversy because
that was horrible.
Basically the Spurs –
they ran the clock out before they threw it in.
Yeah.
But I didn't understand, you know, if you're Pop, you're throwing an alley-oop to somebody. Yes, you want to throw it to Kawhi, right?
That's who it was, right?
But who was guarding Kawhi? Blake.
Yeah,
So Danny Green's getting guarded by Barnes. You could put Ginobili in there. It's just anybody else. I think Duncan maybe tossed up. He probably not. Maybe with DeAndre guarding, but I just thought it was weird that he threw the oop to somebody that Blake Griffin's guarding. You know, that's I thought that was a bad decision. Pop don't make too many bad ones, but maybe he was just flustered by the whole clock thing to begin with. You know, it just didn't work out.
Will Tim Duncan be back?
Yeah.
Yes.
Think he'll be back?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think so. I mean,
they'll all be back.
Will this team be good enough to make another run?
Yeah. I think Ginobili's going to retire.
I think Manu is.
Because, you know, you see he wasn't in there down the stretch. You know,
I would have been mad about that, Bellinelli playing over me. Maybe he's not healthy. We don't know. You know, they would probably, like, if he had something wrong with him or one of these older guys, they would probably keep him as quiet. I think it is possible. We'll see. I think if everybody else comes back, I think Ginobili would be like, let's do it again. If he don't need to be playing in any of these world championships.
No,
because he's been wearing himself out playing all these international stuff.
How old is he now? Now we know
he's
Duncan's
pushing
39.
36, 37.
Yeah, he's mid to late 30s.
Well, I just got a funny feeling every one of them's going to retire at the same time.
Well, I heard that's the thing. I heard Pop say he'll stay as long as Tim stays.
But Parker's a little bit younger than
Parker's
guys.
Parker's 32.
I think he probably won't end up doing that. Maybe Parker, Ginobili, and Pop.
Parker won't be traded.
Ginobili, Duncan, and Pop. Yeah.
I think the key to the success for the Spurs next year is going to be if they can get Kawhi Leonard back. That's going to be the main part of success.
Oh, they're going to get him. They're going to pay him.
Yeah, he's a free agent.
No, he's coming up. He could be his rookie deal is about to end. Okay. He's going to sign that first extension where you sign a 4-year max. So you with your first team for 7 years of your career. They're going to pay him the money, give him that 4-year contract. I mean, no other team can, only other team can offer him is a 3-year deal.
Yeah.
So and why would you? Pretty much become the man on that team, too. Yeah.
I mean, and he's only 23 years old.
He's just 23
years old.
Defensive player of the year already.
Wow.
And finals MVP. Yeah. So. 23.
Pretty impressive.
I want to mention one thing before you jump into something else. We mentioned the Deflate Gate. Y'all, that was two.
How is that not something else, Terry? 200.
Now listen to me. 243 pages to figure this out.
To say that he and, probably and had something to do.
Did you read it?
No. I mean, I can't imagine what you're doing for 243
pages on Deflategate. 93 pages on the Ray Rice issue. Mm-hmm. Where's the priorities?
Yeah, I mean, how? Look, man, we what care do you more about you. Decide to talk
it takes more. It takes more to cover up Tom Brady than it does to convict Ray Rice.
Ray Rice is a videotape. Yeah, you really
90
can't.
Words in a videotape. With Tom Brady's.
Yeah. Each one of these pages had to been on the 72-inch.
While we're on the subject, let's go straight into the meat. How many games is he going to be suspended?
Oh, give me.
Wait a minute. Before you do it, should be. And what you think?
Well, you can do it that way.
However, you know what I mean? Word it
should be suspended? Yes, because it's integrity of the game. If you always talk about the integrity of the game, should be suspended.
How many
number
of
games?
And he's talking about how many should he be.
And how many you think they will?
How many you think they'll actually do?
Should be four. And we'll get four. I'll give you four.
I think he gets four and reduced to two after the appeal.
Really?
That's what I think.
I say should be eight and reduced to four.
Y'all are going to blow y'all's heads off when I say this. Should be the season he will get four or six.
Here's the only problem, okay? We're all still assuming, and I'm going to look at the other side, okay? I'm really in the middle of this. I don't really know which way I lean. But if I look at the devil's advocate here and play the other side, if this was in court, he'd get nothing.
We're not in court.
You know what I mean? I mean, there's no proof. And this guy
is reasonable doubt. That's all you need.
And the bad part is what the guy wrote in his report.
If we were in
the
civil court, he'd be paying money.
The bad part, what he wrote in his report is, I feel like there is more chance he did than he did. Yeah. I mean, that's not going to get you convicted of a crime.
All right, here's the thing. Here's my point of the whole. Is it how big of a deal is the cheating with this football, with the air in the footballs? Okay, if you're playing any sport, golf, basketball, baseball, whatever. Think of what's the worst thing you could do to be called a cheater. You know, I cheated at this game. Isn't it messing with the balls? Isn't it messing with the actual tools
the
of the game?
Yeah,
the equipment?
Say like basketball.
That's the worst thing.
The ball or the rim. Say basketball, you do something to the rim where it's off and it's not even. Or something
switch
like
it at halftime. Mm-hmm. There's a guy up there with a screwdriver. Mm-hmm. Or Rondo's over here deflating the balls because his jump shot goes in. Yeah. I mean, that's the worst possible thing. And as far as quarterbacks go, and it's been proven, the bigger your hand you are, the better you can throw that ball in the NFL. The NFL balls are bigger and slicker than
especially
college
balls.
Especially in cold weather. Brady's been wearing gloves all these years, okay? So that shows you right there he's got a grip problem right there, just the fact he's wearing his gloves. Then he's deflating the ball. I'll tell you right now, that matters a huge deal. I've got small hands. It mattered a huge deal to me. I like the ball with a little less air in it.
Listen
some
to
people
this,
like
too,
like
Kevin.
A full. Kent Bowen liked it like a balloon. He
the
just
Patriots running backs fumbled less than any other team.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely easier to grip and hold on to that ball
absolutely.
With less air.
You, if you're squeezing on
you
to
get
it
popped
like a,
and it don't
like
pop
that
out.
Instead
yeah.
of like that,
yeah.
I mean, if your hand's doing this instead of, you know, clutch.
A lot of different
out,
advantages. It's not just for the quarterback.
Yeah, you're right.
Easier to catch for the receiver.
So, to me, I think that, I mean, that's the – I mean, if I was Brady and I was a quarterback and I couldn't grip it, I would have done the same thing. I'm not going to say he wouldn't.
Now, you said should be season. I forgot what you said you thought it would be.
Six, somewhere right there. I think it will be so they can say, hey, we're tough, and six, and it might get reduced to four or something like that.
The only thing I'm trying to think of as far as integrity of the game, what is it? Like PEDs if you get popped is four games,
yeah.
Right? That's why I'm trying to put it on that level because
the president or the guy get for texting?
I think he got four games for
so
texting.
There's somebody that ain't even on the field, and he's texting a coach on the sideline.
Okay, what about Belichick and them? What's going to happen?
No, Belichick is not found. It's not put anything
I think
on
he's
Belichick.
Out of it.
Everything,
oh, so
everything
we're
going
to say he's out of it like
every,
he had nothing to do with
anything. According to the report, It doesn't. Bill Belichick
as a
not
quarterback. I don't think that Brady would even would say. Would, I don't think he would coach. Say anything to this coach.
I think you bust the whole system.
I don't know any reason you'd need.
I don't think the only person that Brady would need to talk to are those two equipment managers that he's texting with. That's the only person you need to.
Yeah.
Anytime I needed something on the football field, I go to the team manager. Hey,
he might think if I mention this to Belichick, he's not going to let it happen.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Because he's not going to. No, I don't want to get caught. You know.
Right.
We'll get caught cheating for the fourth time.
So now look, four Super Bowls yeah. for the Patriots,
yep.
four controversies. Well, yep. three controversies plus this latest one now. Mm-hmm. So cheating. Mm-hmm.
And a murder trial.
Yeah. They ain't gonna do the Super Bowl there, that one.
I know, but still, you got the owner on the stand during a murder trial.
Which he didn't care for.
No.
You could tell Bob Kraft was very uncomfortable having to do
so. So, Terry,
like
with
that.
All this with the Patriots and this dynasty of theirs in the 2000s, we go back. When's the last real football dynasty?
Yeah,
oh, in the 90s.
Well, in the
90s, I guess
it was. And y'all had the White House. Y'all trying to get it back to those days, aren't y'all? Trying to get it back to the White House, huh? Y'all trying to? Yeah, that's what y'all trying to get.
Nate Newton and his bread trucks too. Mm-hmm.
Back before today's seniors were born. Oh. All right, guys, a good debate, good talking this morning. Plenty of things to talk about. Lots of things going on in the world of sports. We'll now take a time out and be back with more sports talk in a minute.
The money you save in your savings accounts earns interest, so it just makes sense to have your checking account also earn interest for you. A money market checking account pays interest and also offers the flexibility of writing checks. Certain fees may apply. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded just like you.
Here's what's up in Cleveland, Gaston, and Lincoln counties, brought to you by the What's Up Shopper and Big O Country, WOHS, WCSL, and WLON. The Cleveland-Rutherford Kidney Association presents in concert the Four Anointed Quartet and the Foothills Choir on Saturday, May 16th at 6 p.m. at the Mount Sinai Baptist Church in Shelby. A bake sale will also be held. All proceeds will benefit the Kidney Association. For more information, call 704-471-0304. And the Shelby High School Class of 1965 is planning their 50-year reunion on Friday, May 15th and Saturday, May 16th. For more information, call 704-487-8114. And the 2015 Cleveland County Relay for Life is set for Friday, May 15th at the Cleveland County Fairgrounds. That's What's Up, brought to you by What's Up Shopper, Big O Country, WOHS 1390 AM, WCSL 1590 AM, and WLON 1050 AM. For more information, go to whatsupshopper.com.
At the Drugstore Health Mart Pharmacy in Lincoln and Annandale, they treat their customers as if they were family. Health Mart Pharmacies are locally owned pharmacies with a personal commitment to the communities they serve. The Drugstore Health Mart Pharmacy honors prescription plans including Medicare, and Health Mart pharmacists are trusted healthcare resources, knowing that nothing is more important than your family's well-being. Visit your nearest Drugstore Health Mart Pharmacy, 626 Center Drive, Town and Country Shopping Center, Lincoln, and at 9576 Highway 10 in Vail.
There you go, Ann. Your new account is now open. Just one more little thing. Here's your card. What was that?
It's my new bank. Every time I turn around, I get hit with another fee.
You need to get an account at Carolina Federal Credit Union.
She's right.
Tired of getting hit by bank fees? Switch to Carolina Federal Credit Union today. Make those pains go away.
Here's your receipt.
The old saying, you can't keep a good man down, now applies to Brookwood Cafe and Catering. The new Brookwood Cafe and Catering is located on Providence Mill Road in Maiden, featuring the same great food and service you remember. The world's greatest fried chicken and world-famous penny browns once again satisfy your appetite. Brookwood Cafe and Catering is serving the same great breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Brookwood Cafe and Catering on Providence Mill Road in Maiden. Stop by before the game or call ahead for your tailgate items, 828-428-8944.
The colors are in full bloom at Carolina Hardware and Garden Center on the Reeksville Road in Lincoln. From beautiful flowering plants to hanging baskets to all kinds of vegetable plants, you'll find it all. 15 varieties of tomato, pepper plants, and squash, plus 4.5-year proven winter plants and perennials. and Carolina Hardware and Garden Center has water fountains, bird baths, and spring flags, along with a full line of Husqvarna lawn and garden equipment. Carolina Hardware and Garden Center on the Reapsville Road in Lincolnton.
We're community-minded. We believe in what we do. We love this town. We live in just like you.
We're a community bank. That's why we always try to approach things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded. Just like you. Carolina Trust Bank. Member FDIC. Community-minded just like you.
We're community-minded just like you.
And welcome back to Sports Talk. David, Terry, Jason, Kevin, Smoke. Glad to have you with us. Beautiful Saturday morning outside, around 60 couple degrees, sunny. Been some nice weather this week, hadn't it? Mm-hmm. Finally, for a change. Mm-hmm. About had a full week.
No humidity.
Nice weather. It's coming.
Yeah, I know.
Heat, thunderstorms, all of it, I think, coming up this week. As we mentioned, Chicago defeated Cleveland last night, 99-96. Rick and I watched the last quarter of this game after our baseball game. I think Kevin and Smoke did the same thing. They got a chance to see the last quarter. I don't think I saw in that fourth quarter. Did Cleveland lead in the fourth quarter?
No, they tied.
I know they tied a couple times.
Yeah. And Chicago's biggest lead, I think, might have been four. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was just that tied all the way. But I kept thinking, if Chicago don't win this game, they're really going to be sick because – they just never trailed. You know, I mean, they were
not in the fourth. Yeah, in the fourth. They trailed at half. You know,
they were kind of in control the whole second half. But if you lose a game like that after leading just about every minute of the second half, it really bothers you and deflates you. But they got a very exciting win last night on that last second shot by Rose. And, guys, I don't know about how y'all feel about it, but I'm happy for Rose. I mean, he's been through a lot in his career, his injuries. Yeah. He's been injured more than he's been able to play.
And it's sad because he's basically in the prime of his career. He started getting injured right after he won the MVP trophy. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think this is – people always say Grant Hill could have been one of the greats of all time if he just kept – stayed healthy. I think Derrick Rose is a, you know, worst case scenario of that, and he just, it didn't look like he was going to stay healthy at all, and it's just good to see him finally back.
Yeah. Well, I think a lot of people were mad at him the year that he took off after he was hurt, because a lot of people thought he could come back, and he took the whole year, you know. So I think a lot of people got mad at him.
He hurt the other knee. I was on, you know, and Twitter and Instagram, man, they were going in on Rose these last few years. They're talking about the Derrick Rose playoff uniform is a dress suit. That's what it's been the last few years.
It includes a tie.
Yeah, includes a tie. That's his playoff uniform. But to see the shot last night, and that's only his second career game winner, buzzer beater. You know, that's something there. And
don't LeBron have like four?
I think it's not much either. Yeah. And his come in the last few years as well. For Chicago itself, I mean, think about it. The last few years that they played a LeBron James led team, be to be Cleveland or Miami.
Yeah.
They won the first game of the series Chicago has, and then a LeBron team has won the next four. So this is the first time they broke that streak.
Well, that and these series have been pretty physical with LeBron's team and the Bulls. I mean, I remember 2 years ago they were, you know, pushing each other around with the Heat, and it was brutal. So, I mean, could get to that again, but, you know, these series are usually good between LeBron's team and the Bulls.
Oh, well, the rest are letting them play. They were letting them play last night.
Who's in the other?
Think it goes seven?
Atlanta, seven. Yeah, I see it going seven.
Yeah, I could see it going seven. Yeah.
Washington's looked pretty good, too.
Well, so they're hurt pretty big because John Wall's out.
Five partial fractures.
It's going to hurt them.
I thought that was going to be a good series no matter who they play. They were going to compete really well. Well,
Bradley Beal's injured too, right? I mean, he's playing, but he's playing through it.
He's been injured pretty much the whole second half of the year.
Well, guys, while we're on the subject of NBA, I got something for you guys. It was 13 years ago this week.
Talk about practice. We sitting here. I'm supposed to be the franchise player, and we in here talking about practice. I mean, listen, we talking about practice. Not a game. We talking about practice.
One of my favorites all time.
Not a game. Not the game that I go out there and die for. and play every game like it's my last. Not the game. We're talking about practice, man.
How many times is
practice? I mean, how silly is that, man? We're talking about practice. I know I'm supposed to be there. I know I'm supposed to lead by example. I know that. And I'm not shoving it aside, you know, like it don't mean anything. I know it's important. I do. I honestly do. But we're talking about practice, man. What are we talking about?
Does that practice seem like 13 years ago to you guys? No. Smoke, how old were you?
It's been a while since I've seen Iverson on the court.
Four?
I think this is when I was starting to watch SportsCenter and all that stuff. That's one of the first things I remember.
Your dad tell you that's a good example of sportsmanship and hard work?
I know it's not. It just makes me laugh all the time.
No. Oh, it's hilarious.
My favorite line,
it didn't
get to it yet because I know it's long. No. He goes, how am I supposed to be the franchise player and we talking about practice? How am I supposed to make my teammates better? And we talking about
it was practice? Almost like it was rehearsed. Yeah. He was so good at it. You know, I mean, his tones and the way he said the word practice, that's just one of my favorites. And one of my favorites is because it's so funny. Mm-hmm. Him and Jim Mora.
Yeah, I'm about to say, throw Mora's playoffs.
Are probably my two favorites of all time.
Allen Iverson practices, Mora's playoffs, and Diddly Poo. Remember that one?
Diddly
Poo.
Coach
for New Orleans. And then now, and Dennis
Green.
We can't
Green's, do Diddly Poo.
Yeah, and then Dennis Green after that Monday night meltdown. Yeah.
That one. And I didn't really like the guy, but the rant was the Oklahoma State.
Oh, yeah. I'm a man.
I'm 40. What about the Coastal Carolina guy?
Oh,
that started dogs. Meowing like a cat or barking. What was he? He was barking.
You got to be dogs. You can't be cats.
I forgot the other one last year. It was so small school. I forgot the guy. He got mad because his big man went. He goes, my wife can post up better than these guys can.
And all these rants, and we have left out the name Hal McCray.
Yeah,
who used to be one of the best. Yeah. Hal McCray at breaking telephones, slamming telephones. Mm-hmm. And this wasn't really a rant, but the argument that the Asheville Tourist coach made in minor league baseball years ago. Where he throws second base in the outfield, he gets on his belly and crawls like
is
an
inchworm.
That's
the one that threw the grenade.
Threw the grenade.
The Braves minor league affiliate. Yeah.
Seemed rehearsed, didn't it? Mm-hmm. Seemed rehearsed. He had learned it somewhere.
You can't forget some of Mike Dicka's stuff. Those are some of the hilarious. And Ozzie Guillen.
Ozzie was pretty good. Yeah, those Ozzie's I can't play.
No.
Yeah. Of course, I understand. But also another anniversary that happened this past week. I think it was the 26th anniversary of Jordan's game winner against the Cavs.
Yeah, that happened. That was May. What was yesterday? May the 8th.
Yeah,
it was May 7th, 1989 with Jordan's, and then May 8th yesterday with Derrick Rose. So
and Babe Ruth hit his first home run back in 1915.
Mike Powell mentions Mike Singletary.
So. Oh yeah,
meltdown.
Can't play with him. Won't do
that's exactly
it.
What
can't
he put
do
on
it.
Here.
Won't do I it. Won't win us.
That's exactly what he
won't
put on
do
here.
It.
And
can't
what,
do it.
What Longley was out the door.
Yeah.
He couldn't do it.
San Francisco told him. San Francisco, we want winners, man.
We'd like to have them ourselves.
And while we talk, congratulations. We didn't mention congratulations, Steph Curry, MVP. He broke the streak of LeBron James winning the MVP. And
out of Davidson College. NBA MVP.
Out of Charlotte, North Carolina.
You know he can't get his jersey retired until he goes back and get his degree. They can't
right, Davidson will not do it. Davidson will not retire a jersey without a degree. That is
who
exactly
cares?
Right.
Exactly right.
But I bet he does it.
I'm sorry, Davidson. My jersey retired in the NBA.
I'm sure they're taking his money if he's donating back to the school, though.
They have enough money at Davidson just to have to worry about anything from Steph Curry. Yep.
They have plenty of money. Major League Baseball last night, the Yankees continue to win. They beat Baltimore 5-4, Washington over Atlanta 9-2, Phillies over the Mets 3-1. Kevin's Cardinals rolling too, 8-5 last night over Pittsburgh.
Yeah, that's their best
Best
start ever. Yeah.
21-6, is that what they are?
22-7. Okay. It was the best start since like 1899. Without Wayne, I feel good about this regular season.
Oh yeah, because you just lost the pitch.
But,
right? Yeah.
Wainwright's a stud. He's the ace you need in the playoffs.
Who replaced him?
Waka is our net is pretty much.
Yeah, but he's
not
bad.
He's fourth in the ERA right now.
Who did they bring up as the fifth starter? Do you know who they brought
in? Carlos Martinez moved from the bullpen last year. We've got John Lackey.
Lackey's pitching well.
The thing is, we need to call the Braves back, and they can take – y'all want Hayward back, and we want Shelby Miller back. Because this trade that everyone – every Braves fan I know called or text me – congratulations, you got Hayward. And I told him, he's not even going to start on our team because he's not good enough to play on our team. And then what's he doing now? He's batting like .210. He can't
hit
the ball. He's awful. He's just completely awful. And if y'all want him back, well, y'all can have him. Anytime. We need our pitcher. We need
for
a
23rd round draft pick.
We think. All right. We probably and should make the playoffs. But once it gets there, I mean, right now you guys know it's a toss up. Once playoffs start, depends on the matchups, depends on weather, depends on where the teams are. But without Wainwright, it's just going to be really tough.
And who's hot at the time? And you know as well as anybody, you don't want to be peaking at your best right now. Yeah. You want to be peaking at your best around
the
September.
The Oakland A's can tell you that from experience from last year. They were hot, they were extremely hot on fire until the trade deadline when they traded for all those pitchers, and then they didn't have any hitting.
You're right. Then they had to play Kansas City.
Yeah.
In the ring.
I saw something the other day. We were talking about the Houston Astros. Yep. There's something about their turnaround or their start or the games they won in a row that it's equal to the start of Seattle Mariners' all-time record start. Something about the American League West. I can't remember the exact ways that worked out.
Well, they were hot till the latter part of this week. I think they lost a couple.
That might have been what they were talking about. They had won ten in a row at one time.
But last year, SportsCenter made a guarantee. Sports Illustrated made a guarantee, putting them on the front cover, saying they're going to be the 2017 MLB World Series champions. They have a great corp of young group.
Might be a year
guys.
Early.
Jose Altuve, Chris Carter. I mean, he's up and down.
30.
Wow.
You also got former Braves Evan Gattis, who's
Gattis
been
is tearing it
not,
up too.
Yeah. So I mean, Astros. It's hard to imagine. Just 10 years ago, they were in the World Series.
Oh, in the World Series.
Last
year they were horrible.
What it was is that the only teams with a 10-game winning streak this early in the season. Was the last team to do that was the Seattle Mariners that won the
and they were loaded
record.
Then.
Yeah, they were
too.
So there's some
one thing going for Houston. They are very young, very young. So there again, Terry, like your Royals, can they keep them there? Can they keep them there when those contracts start?
That's
going to
be the
down?
Big
well,
deal.
I think they'll start wanting
Houston's
to spend money.
Biggest city in the country. They shouldn't have a problem. Or fourth.
Yeah, they'll start spending the money. I think that was the year they were trying to build up their farm system. Wasn't spending the money on the big league team, and you know. It was brought up in some articles talking about how they were basically just mailing in the season these last few years for the
Before that Houston was always the Cardinals' problem. They were always the ones spending the money and going after the big guys and the big names and everybody.
They had Clemens, Pettit,
Randy Johnson. You know he pitched.
They went after everybody. I mean, they did. They spent the money to go after everybody.
They had Berkman. They had a lot of great pieces back then. And
did Nolan Ryan spend some time?
Yeah, he pitched for him too.
J.R. Richards.
He did.
Jason Younger.
Oh, man. I know he's pitched for him.
He pitched for Astros, Angels, Rain. He pitched for three of those teams now in the AL West, and there was one more team he pitched for off the top of my head. I can't remember. Somebody
Mets. Did he pitch for the Mets?
May have. Finished the scores last night. My Red Sox stay hot. They get beat 7-0 last night. Toronto, either they can't score – or they can't get pitching. They cannot put the two together. Last night, 7-0, Toronto shuts them out. Detroit over Kansas City, 6-5.
We only lose in two ways. Either our players get thrown out or we make error.
Neither one are good.
City bad boys.
Minnesota over Cleveland, 9-3. Tampa Bay beats Texas, 8-2. White Sox Reds rained out. Cubs beat Milwaukee 7-6. Dodgers last night in six innings rained out, shortened game. Dodgers beat Colorado 2-1. San Diego over Arizona 6-5. The Angels beat Houston last night by a score of 2-0. And in 11 innings, Seattle knocks off Oakland 4-3. And late last night, West Coast, San Francisco 6 and Miami 0. Does anybody know right off top if that was a Bumgarner? Pitched game either. I'll check that out in a minute. A shutout win for the Giants. The Yankees, if it's not the Houston Astros, then it's the New York Yankees that are the hottest in the American League, along with Minnesota, believe it or not. We'll get there in a minute. But the Yankees are 19-11. They lead Tampa by 3.
A-Rod, officially fourth place on the all-time home run list.
Don't even acknowledge it.
661 home runs. A-Rod passes Willie Mays the all-time home run list.
To make them mad.
It's funny how little attention it got.
Yeah.
Really. Mm-hmm. Even in New York.
Heck, he's getting booed everywhere he goes now.
But he's tearing up the baseball. I will give him credit for that.
He's hitting.
He's one of the reasons they have 19 wins. Mm-hmm. Toronto is 4 games out of first, Boston 5.5, and the Orioles also 5.5. Central Division, Terry, it's going to be a good race from wire to wire, is it not? Detroit, a half a game up on Kansas City right now. Detroit's 19-11, Kansas City 18-11.
Watch out, Minnesota.
But how about this? Out of nowhere, the Twins win 8 out of 10, And they are 17-13 and just two games out of first place behind these two.
Bad news for Minnesota, though. They're only 5-8 on the road. So that's got to come back to get them right there.
They're the team that if you look at Kansas City's losses, I know we got 11. I guarantee Minnesota gave us five of them.
Yeah.
Brett says it was Linscomb last night with the shutout. Okay. Bumgarner on the hill tonight.
Now, Terry, I do want to say something good about your Royals here, if you believe it or not. I like to pick on you and stuff, but I got nothing against the Royals besides y'all
hit
cheated to beat us in the World Series one time. Besides y'all cheated to beat us in a World Series 30 years ago. Anyway.
I wasn't born yet.
Anyway, what I like to look at when you look at the standings and you know, you see the records and everything, the records don't always tell the stories. Look at home road stuff. The run differential. When you look at run differential, that's always tells the keys. Usually the top four or five teams, those are your World Series teams. Well, Terry, your Royals right now, second in the division, but you're third overall in a run differential behind the Cardinals and the Dodgers. So the Cardinals are plus 50, Dodgers 47, and the Royals 42. So, I mean, and everybody else is in the 20s or negative almost. So those three teams dominate in run differential right now. So that's good news for your Royals.
Yeah, well, the biggest pickup we have was Morales. He is the one that's been a stud for us that's just killing the ball. The
Royals are losing the tight games. That's what that tells you. When it comes to the one-run games, they're losing a few. After the Twins, the White Sox are 6.5 out. The Indians are 8 games out. In the West, Houston, even though they've lost 4 of their last 10 now, they were very hot. Houston is 19-11, leading the American League West.
Which is the only team with a winning record.
It is, yep. The Angels are second, and they're 2 games below .500. They're 5 games back. Then comes Seattle, Texas, and Oakland. The Mets, they've cooled off somewhat, but still have a decent lead in the National League East. The Mets are 18-11. Washington now has finally turned things around, starting to play like folks thought
they
would.
Bryce Harper.
At the beginning of the season, yes. Hit 3 home runs, 1 game.
He had five home runs in two games.
He's the youngest player to do so. They had 5 home runs in the 2 games straight.
Well, they've won 8 out of 10, and they have pulled to within 3.5 of the Mets. The Braves come in next at 4 back, Miami 4.5, and the Phillies at 7.5. Your St. Louis Cardinals, 22-7, best record in baseball, won 9 out of their last 10. 22-7 gives them a 6.5 game lead over the Cubs, 7.5 over Cincinnati, 9 over Pittsburgh, and 13.5 over Milwaukee. Milwaukee, by the way,
they're done.
Is the only team that has not reached double digits with a win.
That's what I was about to say. In that division, Milwaukee's the only team that hasn't won 10 games, and St. Louis is the only team in baseball that hasn't lost 10 games.
The Dodgers have put a little separation between them and the Padres, winning 7 of their last 10. The Dodgers are 19-10. Padres 4 back. The Giants starting to play a little better now, won 7 out of 10. They're 4.5 back. Arizona 5.5, and the Colorado Rockies are 7 games out of first place. Any surprises to you guys, or bad?
Well, my deal with this, if you are – by the time you get to 50 games and you already in double digits, losses behind, your season is done. I mean, that's just me. And we ain't even got to 50 games.
Even with wild cards.
Yes. I think you're done. You're finished.
I think the biggest surprise is the two teams atop of the AL East. You know, before the season, people were saying, oh, it's going to be the Red Sox and Orioles on top.
Yep.
Well, the Orioles and Red Sox are tied.
Flip-flop.
But they're on the bottom.
That's right.
And the Yankees are leading the division, and the Tampa Bay Rays are 3 games behind, an extremely young team. They got probably one of the most underrated star pitchers out there in Chris Archer. He's a really good pitcher, and they got a
new manager.
Kevin Cash. He's doing a pretty good job. Lots of young guys, so it's going to be interesting to see what the Rays look like as the year goes on.
I think that AL East is going to flip-flop. I think everybody in that division can lead that.
I think the Yankees
can lead that
it.
Division.
If the Yankees don't have injuries, they'll win it because – well, you're talking about run differential. I mean, they have a plus 30 right now, looking pretty strong in that department. And if A-Rod stays healthy, continues to hit like he is, because all of a sudden he and Teixeira are back like they were, you know, 3 or 4 years ago. They're hitting the ball real good. And the surprise for the Yankees has been their pitching staff. They're getting
talking
really
depending
good
on A-Rod's workout program.
can't be 100% sure.
My biggest surprise is the Astros. I'm sorry.
It is.
I mean,
oh, there's
they
no
were
doubt.
Awful. And,
in baseball.
And now they're in first, and nobody else in that division has a winning record. I mean, the Angels spent how much millions of dollars to not even have a winning record?
Here's a surprise, too, in a way, because didn't the Milwaukee Brewers last year lead their division for half the season?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
And then, bam.
Yes.
They
just
Pittsburgh,
fell off
and now they're in the –
but Milwaukee, I mean, is 9 wins, and it's like they picked up where they left off at the end of last year. What happened? I mean, they
maybe
didn't lose people, did they?
Well, I'm also like Smoke. Smoke was talking about the Oakland A's. Look what's happened when they did make them trades last year. Look what's happened to them.
Yeah, you usually totally don't see them 12-19 this time.
Well,
this time of year.
I think another shocker, just because I feel like they're doing better than I thought they would, are the Chicago Cubs. They're two games above 500. I know they're 6.5 back. They won't catch up to the Cardinals.
When Milwaukee's 9-21, somebody's got to beat them.
yeah, but you know, I think that if the Cubs don't make the playoffs, they don't.
The
but
Bryant kid,
it's
he's scary.
Just
he's
a
little scary.
It's just
he's pretty
good
sharp.
Sign for the Cubs.
You're right, Smoke.
I just try and take a look here. If you know, if at the end of the day, obviously you got your division winners, and you've got the Yankees in the playoffs. The Tigers are in. The Astros are in. Your two wild cards would be Kansas City and Tampa Bay. I'm wrong. Minnesota. Scratch Tampa Bay. Be Kansas City and Minnesota.
We're in for trouble if that happens.
If the playoffs started today, but they don't. You know, we only got
about
8 months left.
Only got 130 games left.
That's the two teams that cheated the Cardinals in the 80s.
Baseball is so up and down.
We always cheat. Whatever it takes to win.
Every team will go on a losing streak. Every team will go on a winning streak, you know. The Mets would be in the playoffs along with the Cardinals, of course, and the Dodgers. Your wild card today would be the Cubs, would be one of your wild cards. And then it's a fiasco with the Nationals, the Cincinnati Reds at 500. I guess
like
it would be
Padres,
the Padres with that half-game edge over them. So how about that? And nobody's talking about them. Nobody's mentioned the Padres. And
I couldn't name one player on the Padres.
Well, Braves traded their closer, Kimbrel.
Yeah. They made a lot of off-season trades last year. I bet they got six new starters.
Yeah.
And they got the
Kemp, ain't Kemp there?
Yeah, he is.
And the Oakland brothers, too.
So they made some moves to get there.
So they got all
the Atlanta Braves, yeah.
My biggest surprise should be the Tigers, because I said they would be the team that would tank this year and wouldn't be anywhere in the mix, and they're in first place in their division.
Shows how much you know.
Exactly. I expected Verlander's still
– he's still
not
hurt.
Playing.
Out?
Yeah,
still not pitching. And, of course, they lost Scherzer, which was their two top starters, hadn't even pitched for them. And they're still in
pitching
first place.
Pitching don't mean nothing.
They
got
still
Cabrera.
Got pitching.
Evidently.
You got Porcelain. You got Dagan Price. I mean, they can still throw
Price,
guys out.
Yeah. Don't forget about Price. But also, you got hitters. The big trade they made in the offseason was getting another hitter out in left field, a guy named Yoenis Cespedes from the Red Sox, to trade for Rick Porcello, who's not, you know, top option, but he's a good 3, 4, 5 pitcher in the rotation, more of a ground ball pitcher.
That trade's been good for both teams.
Yes, Porcello's probably been the best pitcher for the Red Sox, easily.
There's a rundown of Major League Baseball. We'll take a timeout. We come back, we'll look at high school sports. A big week this past week, and now playoffs coming up in high school sports.
Those sweltering days of summer are coming. You can keep cool with just one call to IMA Heating and Air Conditioning in Shelby, your Cleveland County Trane dealer. And right now, when you buy a qualifying Trane system, you pay no interest till January of 2020, or choose a trade-in allowance of up to $1,150. Again, no interest till January of 2020, or a Trane trade-in allowance of up to $1,150. See IMA Heating and Air Conditioning for all the details. 2409 South Post Road in Shelby. Call 704-481-1144. You'll feel like you've hit a home run when you move into your new Silver Point home from Silver Point Homes in Lincoln. Why rent when you can own a new custom modular home for less? Silver Point Homes in Lincoln has thousands of floor plans to choose from, with 6 display models on site that are now drastically reduced. Yes, they're built better and faster and for less. Come see for yourself at Silver Point Homes, 2125 East Main Street in Lincoln. Online at silverpointhomes.com. Come on home to Silver Point Homes. Check out the everyday specials of the Woodbridge Handy Mart, like 2-liter Sun Drops, just 99 cents every day. 16-ounce Monster Energy drinks, 2 for $3.50. Seal Test milk, just $3.99 a gallon. And Made Right Old Fashioned bread, only $1.69 a loaf. Plus Hunt Brothers Pizza and Wings all day long, every day. Plus, the Sandwich Grill is open till 2 p.m. Monday through Friday. And cool off with 6 flavors of slushes. The Woodbridge Handy Mart, Stony Point Road at the Woodbridge Golf Course. Like them on Facebook, too.
Is the cost of ink driving your profits down? Then listen up. Discount Inkjet and Toner is here to help. And now they have a new additional location in Shelby at 1725 East Dixon Boulevard, just below Crossroads Ford. Discount Inkjet and Toner specializes in refilling inkjet and toner cartridges. cut your ink cost by as much as 50% or more. Discount inkjet and toner. 410 East Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia, and now open in Shelby at 1725 East Dixon Boulevard in the former Little Moo location. 100% satisfaction guaranteed.
You care about the future of this community. You grew up here. You've raised a family here. Your life is here. So is ours. Carolina Trust Bank. Member FDIC.
Community minded, just like you.
It's time we refocus our attention and concern from drugs, drug laws, to human beings. Teach your kids the harmful effects of drug abuse. Knowing the facts will help your children make healthy choices. A tip from Firestone Fibers and Textiles Company in Kings Mountain. They know Kings Mountain, and it's a good place, and they're doing their part to keep it that way. That's Firestone Fibers and Textiles Company in Kings Mountain, a caring community leader always concerned for the future, safety, and welfare of our children.
Mr. Sparky, we're on time, you'll see. Mr. Sparky, all your repair is free.
Back with Rusty Wise from Mr. Sparky. You told me about this top 10 list of things people said they couldn't live without, and food and water wasn't even on there.
It was things like cell phone, microwave, internet service.
Well, that's why it's kind of nice to know Mr. Sparky offers generators.
Yes, Mr. Sparky offers Generac generators. We're an elite dealer in the Charlotte market. We can service, repair, and do the install and offer financing also. The generator system comes on by itself, monitors the utility, and when the utility power comes back on, the system turns off. You don't have to do a thing. If you currently have a generator system, let us come out and make sure it works properly.
Mr. Sparky, we're on time, you'll see. Mr. Sparky, all your repair is free.
If you lost power for a day or more, where would you be?
Don't put it off. Call Mr. Sparky, 888-8-SPARKY.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
Welcome back to Sports Talk. Glad to have you with us on a Saturday morning. David, Terry, Jason, Kevin, and Smoke on the board. Before we get back into the sports, we're going to talk high school sports. We're going to check in with Calvin and Perk. What's going on, guys?
Hey, thank you there, David. We are at Crossroads Ford, and Perk, it's the first annual May Day Car Show.
And we have beautiful Big Red out here to show herself off, don't we, Calvin?
Yep, we got Big Red parked along the road. Come on by. You can't miss it. If you're going down 74, we're parked right in front. Just Big Red's in front of us up on the grass, so we're ready to go.
We're right here going out here today. We're going to have a beautiful time. It's a beautiful morning out here. We're going to have some other people out. We're going to have giveaways. They're going to be giving away some of the cars that come out. All they have to do is register. Same with us. All you got to do is come out. Have a Subway on us today, some chips and drink, and we'll be giving our prizes away later on today.
That's right. Subway of Cherryville. We're going to have some sub sandwiches.
Sub sandwiches. Great sandwiches.
They will be good. Subway going to be here about 10 o'clock.
About 10.
So come on out. Plan now to come on out and see us. We got some prizes we're giving away. Burke, yes, what are we giving away?
We're going to give away some of the fabulous Fairground Speedway racing tickets. We're going to give away free rounds of golf at the Deerbrook Golf Course. Going to give away 4 tickets to the Hickory Crawdads. If you like baseball, come by and register and get you a ticket. Giving away a $25 gift card to Newt's. Some of them famous What's Up t-shirts, and just going to have a ball out here today.
What's up? There you go. All right. They want to invite everybody to come out, no matter what kind of car. If you've got a Chevrolet, a Ford, a Pontiac, a Buick, a Dodge, whatever you got, bring it out. All makes and models welcome today here at Crossroad Ford.
That's exactly right. I just looked over and they got 3,400 new vehicles available. They can have you any car you want to on the shop that you want. They can have it here to you in 3 hours or less.
You better believe it. Come check it out. We'll talk about some of the deals going on here today. Crossroads Ford, Highway 74 east of Shelby. And it's, right at the intersection of South Post Road. Easy to find.
Easy to find. All you got to do is look for us. You'll find the big old blue and white sign in the air.
All right. David, we'll send it back to you and more sports talk right here at Big O Country.
Thank you, Calvin, and we will check back in just a little bit. Calvin and Perk at Crossroads Ford in Shelby. Get out there and check them out. See what's going on today, what the giveaways are, and what the good deals are at, on the lot today. So we'll check in with those guys in just a little bit. The East Lincoln Mustangs last night fell in the conference tournament. It's kind of like a shocker. I mean, East Lincoln boys this year have won everything. Yeah. You know, I mean, football championship, basketball conference championship, baseball conference championship, and now they fall to Bunker Hill last night in a very, very competitive game last night. Bunker Hill, one of the most improved teams. This Bunker Hill team is now 20-6, so they're not shabby themselves at all. You know, Bunker Hill team made it to the state championship last year, mm-hmm. lost 2-1 to Midway, and now seem to have it rolling again. But East Lincoln trailed 3-2 late in the game. 2-0 late in the game. Got three runs in the bottom of the sixth to take the lead. Looked like they're going to get to close out and win. Bunker Hill won't go away. They get three runs themselves, all three with two outs in the seventh inning. And come away with the victory last night over the East Lincoln Mustangs. Congratulations to both those teams, East Lincoln on the conference championship, Bunker Hill on the tournament championship. Also in SD7, the West Lincoln girls, Terry, we talked about that a little bit. Coach Tyler Sane's girls, back-to-back conference titles, now back-to-back tournament titles as well. And you said they did not give up a run in the three conference tournament games.
15-0, 10-0, and 5-0.
So they just cut it down by five runs every time. So playing in five.
Glad they didn't have to play another one. Been tired.
Yeah. Yeah, they'd still be playing. Yeah. They sure would. Also, a couple nights ago, we mentioned this huge game in the SMAC conference, 15 inning affair. I kept up with it as long as I could that night. It went to like 11:30 at night on a Tuesday night, but Burns did pull out the win over Crest by a score of 8-3. And that game was 3-3, 3-3, 3-3, 3-3, every inning, right, Smoke?
Three
became a common number.
It was a pretty low-scoring game. No one scored until the fourth inning. Burns knocked a two-run homer, and then Crest knocked a two-run homer in the bottom of the fourth. Mm-hmm. Then in the sixth inning, Burns scored another run, then Crest scored another run, and they were basically scoreless for the rest of the way until the 15th inning when Burns got five runs in. I mean, Crest pitching was phenomenal in that game. They had about a combined total of 24 strikeouts in that game. And Chase Burnham for Burns went 10 innings strong for the Burns Bulldogs. And Matt Bridges had six innings in relief for the Crest Chargers, and he basically pitched the whole game. So just a phenomenal.
I was saying he had 16 Ks in relief.
Wow, 16 strikeouts in relief.
Yeah, that's part of the reason. But, I mean, both teams had multiple opportunities. Both teams had bases loaded. Crest was only one ball away from walking the winning run in with the bases loaded, and Burns held them off. Just phenomenal game. The only bad part was it was extremely late for a weekday game.
Yes, but nobody expected. Nobody right. ever expects the two games in one, as you guys had there a couple nights ago. So,
and you can watch the replay on KTC Broadcasting's YouTube page. Just go into youtube.com/KTC Broadcasting. Kevin's getting up the video right now for the East Lincoln game last night. It was at Hickory Fairgrounds, and we also got the Cherville games from this past week against East Rutherford on Monday, and the conference championship game against Lincoln Charter Thursday night.
It's been, like I said, it's been a big week.
Yes, it has.
In high school sports, conference tournaments, the conference regular season's winding down. Burns, by virtue of that win over Crest, will take the number one seed into the playoffs out of the SMAC conference. They finish as a conference overall champion. If I'm not mistaken, East Rutherford is set to take the number one seed for the 2A out of that conference. So they'll be at home for a couple playoff games as well. Should be interesting to see when the playoff matchups come out today.
When the playoffs start?
Wednesday. The day they have to start by. You can't. Some games, I've already heard some coaches say that they're probably going to move theirs to Tuesday. It's set up like it was a couple years ago for Wednesday and Saturday, mm-hmm. but most coaches will play the Tuesday, Friday with the Wednesday, Saturday set for rain. Yeah, makeup days. There could be some teams that feel like they're better served to play on Wednesday, you know, to get their pitching back set and back in order. So we could still see that happen too. But we'll know. You know, it'll be right here. We'll give the schedule out here during the week here on KTC Broadcasting, and of course your local papers will have the schedules and everything of our local teams as well. Terry, what else you got over there in the way of high school sports, either last night or from this past week?
Yeah, the only other scores we had, Crest defeated Shelby last night 10-1, and it was Kings Mountain over East Burke 12-3, and we mentioned Cherville defeated Lincoln Charter 8-4 on Thursday. In softball action, it was Bessemer City over Highland Tech yesterday for third place, 6-5, but day before, Lincoln Charter had won a championship over Cherville for 15-0. So,
I wish I had the all conference teams for all of our local conferences. The only one I have was sent to me by Conference Commissioner Tom Watson, which is the SD7 baseball all conference team. Local kids in our area that made all conference: Seth Harding's out of Bandy's, Cameron Chapman, Clay Irvin, Justin Setzer, Cooper Ray out of Bunker Hill, Jordan Easter from Lincolnton, Dalton Hefner, Caden O'Brien, Aaron Rudisell from Maiden. Newton Conover had Nicholas Lofton and Alex Mincer, Wes Lincoln, Mac George, Sam High, Alec Johnson, Colton Miller. East Lincoln, the conference champions, placed 5 on the all-conference team: Austin Buchanan, Alec Burleson, Chris Cox, Nate Kinch, and Carson Philemon. Your coach of the year was Chris Mateel. Your defensive player of the year, Chris Mateel is East Lincoln, by the way, for folks that don't know. Your defensive player of the year, also from East Lincoln, Chris Cox. And your offensive player of the year, Aaron Rudisell from Maiden. So I thought was a terrific hitter, probably the best hitter I saw all year of all the games I saw, leadoff hitter for the Maiden Blue Devils. So congratulations to those folks on their all-conference performances for this season. And also, while we're on the talking about other things that have happened, can't go without mentioning Cherville's tell me if he's a leadoff hitter, Jimmy Johnson. Does he bat leadoff for the
No, he bats like 6 or 7.
About 6 or 7, okay. Jimmy Johnson, a senior at Cherville High, recently received the Junior Firefighter of the Year Award presented by the National Volunteer Fire Council. Johnson also has a 3.3 GPA and a position as starting center fielder and leadoff hitter for the school's baseball team. Headlines today in the Gazette say, not your typical student. So if you get a chance, get you a Gazette today. Pick it up, not in sports, but on page 1B, the hometown section of the Gazette. A good story today on Jimmy Johnson, who goes beyond the baseball field.
And while we also want to congratulate Chad Surratt winning the North Carolina High School Athletic Association Male Athlete of the Year.
Yes.
I got a lot of congratulations.
Only one given.
This week's What's Up Shopper just came out, guys. So today is brand new on the cover of this week's is the WHS
Nelson
at the FCA Sports Awards. Every year in Cleveland County, we give away a Sports Fan of the Year Award. It's our favorite award to give away because it acknowledges, you know, the people that come and actually support these teams, support the fans. This year's winner was Nelson Royster up at Burns, Lawndale. If you know anything about Burns, if you've ever been to a Burns game, Nelson is there. He's now the official Twitter feed and Facebook account manager for those.
He is an avid tweeter.
So if you need to know anything about Burns, or if you need to know every single thing in the Atlanta Braves game, you can follow Nelson along as well. But what congratulations, Nelson. Great guy and a great fan. A lot of support he does up there at Burns. Also at Burns, you guys, for you golfers out there, coming up June 19th, folks, put this on your calendars, July 19th. Let me change that. The Dan Greer Memorial Golf Tournament to raise money for the Burns football program. It's actually a 3-man's captain's choice, not a 4-man's, at Deerbrook, you know, limited to 36 teams. So we'll probably do broadcasting actually from that golf tournament. We do we'll do broadcasting up at Catawba Springs to raise money up at East Lincoln. So we'll probably actually do like a live probably on one of the par threes. We'll have a live video camera so you guys come through and see how good you do on the par three. There maybe a hole, let's see, 10, 11, hole 12 will probably be where we set up there at the parking lot. So we'll have a good time with that. So come out and play. Sign up for that. I'm going to go through also each week, guys, in the What's Up Shopper. All the ads, real quick, are online too. So if you find something online in the paper, if you get about it, hey, I want to see that ad or what did I see, go to whatsupshopper.com, click on the shopping section. You can find a section in the paper. You can find your ads, find everything in the paper is in it. Real quick, I'm going to go through for Calvin's sports this week while we're congratulating people. Crest Chargers, Jarrett Kanes and Adissa Usery have been named to the East-West All-Star Basketball Game in July. Gaston Days, Harrison Romero signed to play soccer at NC State. Let's see. Mitch Harris made it to the big leagues this week for the St. Louis Cardinals. Former South Point Raider. I think I might have played again. That name sounds familiar. I think he's close to my age. Let's see. Gardner Webb, undrafted free agent Kenny Cook, signed with the Kansas City Chiefs. He's a two-time All-American.
How about that? That's impressive.
So, let me finish up real quick, and we can get right back to it. Couple of things. North Lincoln guys up there. Evan, tell me about your golf team real quick. The one that's eighth straight North Piedmont Championship.
Yeah, Austin Taylor, Jake Haynes, Ben Hagard, a very good golf group, and Coach Mark Glack, he's always done a great job with the golf program at North Lincoln. Two-time state champions, and they won it back-to-back, and they're still doing really good being in a different division. That golf team has just always been a bright spot in North Lincoln's athletic program, so great job for them. And they have a pretty tough time in that conference.
Right,
and
it's a good conference.
The district that they're in is pretty hard, too, going against.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of good golf courses and golf up in that area. So
it just makes it more impressive.
Austin Taylor, you mentioned him. He was named the golfer of the year. Teammates Jake Haynes and Aaron Dyer were named All-Conference. Ashbrook girls won the Big South Track and Field Championship. Kings Mountain girls captured the Cleveland County Track and Field Championship. The Big South Championship, Hunter Huss, 2A singles title, Adam Nesnow. Forest View took home the championship of first annual North Lincoln Golf Tournament last week at Vertic Ridge. Actually, there, so you couldn't defend the home turf there, Evan. What happened?
I don't know.
Talk to you boys up there and figure that out. But they're the state champions. They got the ring, so it don't matter.
Also, East-West game, I think I saw that. Damaris Valentine and Trishan Dennis from East Lincoln.
Playing
an East-West
football
game.
Football game, it sure will.
All right. A couple other things real quick. Forest View new basketball coach, Chris Rayfield. Ashbrook just named their new basketball coach. I didn't catch his name. It was on Twitter.
Phil tweeted it out yesterday.
Best Mercedes track team won their first conference championship in school history. Congratulations. And that's big because, guys, I mean, if you not know familiar with Best City, I mean, Darren Sanders ran. I mean, he was All-State back when in the early 90s. I thought they might have won one back then, but apparently they didn't. The Yellow Jackets junior D.H. Crawford was named MVP, and for the girls, Community School of Davidson was first place. The Ashbrook new athletic director is Jake Eccles.
The coach is 12-year JV head coach Richard Karsner has been brought up down to lead the varsity. It's good to see the guys get promoted from within.
Let's see if there's anything else. The rest of everything else, guys, you can read in Calvin's article every week. We go over the
love to recognize the high school athletes.
That's what we're all about.
That's what we want to do.
And Terry, the last thing in the article, West Lincoln Lady Rebels captured their second straight championship with a 5-win over East Lincoln last week, and they won. Did they win the tournament? The
tournament
last night?
Also.
Won the tournament last night also, so congratulations.
Even with Tyler Sane as the
I know,
coach.
I just don't see how that happens. I mean, how in the world?
Great talent beats great coaching.
Yeah, it really does. I mean, it's just unbelievable.
How about that?
They shall overcome, Jason.
Congratulations, Tyler, and your girls as well. An impressive run, an impressive 2-year run. And, you know, Terry mentioned it earlier, conference tournament didn't allow a run. 15-0, 10-0, 5-0. So pretty impressive run there to end the season. And all the high school coaches will be clicking on NCHSAA today and try and find out when the brackets come out.
That's why they wait till later, because they'll make more money clicking on their website. Look
at all these hits we have.
Come on, we've got it figured out. We got it now.
There was another thing I wanted to mention, too, because we spend so much time on baseball and softball and football, basketball, whatever the major sports are. But, you know, it's not every day that we get a local boxer that's going to make an appearance. Mount Holly resident Jose Velasquez set to make his amateur boxing debut at the Mayor's Cup in Spring Lake on Saturday night. Velasquez, 21 years old, will compete in the 4th annual Mayor's Cup in Spring Lake near Fayetteville.
Yep.
The event begins with weigh-ins at 10 a.m. That's today. That's going on. I'm assuming it says Saturday, so I'm assuming that happens today. So just right when we go off the air this morning, he'll be making his boxing debut. We don't have a whole lot of that around here in our area anymore. So good to see that as well.
All right, folks, you get a chance today. Go out and see Calvin at the first annual May Day Car Show today, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. Calvin and Perk will be out there at 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. with a free lunch for some fun surprises. Terry, they said, what, they have Subway sandwiches today? So get you a good Subway turkey sandwich or ham sandwich over there at Crossroads Fords in Shelby. That's 1775 East Dixon Boulevard. They'll be partying all day today. Bring your cars. All kind of cars are welcome. Dad's in his 68 Ford XL cruising over there. Bring your cars in and cruise.
There you have it. There's a rundown of high school sports. We'll take a timeout. Back with more sports talk in a moment.
Your 2015 Atlanta Braves are ready for a huge season, and you'll catch it all right here.
Duran ready to go, and here it comes. Swinging a miss. He dropped a hammer on it. Strikes out the side. That's 11 Ks.
Atlanta Braves baseball right here at Big O Country. WHS Shelby, WLO in Lincoln, WCSL Charitable Gastonia. Online at KDCBroadcasting.com.
Check out the daily specials at the all-new Fairways and Greens restaurant at the Lincoln Country Club in Lincoln. Monday night is 45-cent wing night, dine-in only. Tuesday is Taco Tuesday. Wednesday night is live trivia starting at 7:30. Thursday night is sandbagger steak night with ribeyes. And Friday night is pasta night. Salad, bread, and pasta all for $6.95. Takeout is available by calling 704-732-4662, extension 4. The new Fairways and Greens restaurant at the Lincoln Country Club.
Phil Wallace at the Riverbend YMCA Golf Course invites you to come on over and play. The course has a brand new look that we think you'll really like. And the greens feature the new Mini Verde grass greens. Call for your tee time today at Riverbend at this number, 704-482-4286. Come and play today, and you'll be coming back soon to the Riverbend YMCA Golf Course off Highway 150 West on Longwood Drive, Shelby.
We're a community bank. That's why we always try to approach things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded, just like you. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded, just like you.
We're community-minded, just like you.
The best way to protect your child from getting involved in substance abuse is to talk with your kids at an early age about making healthy choices. A community service reminder made possible by Walmart, where they're passionate about helping people live better. It's why Walmart is working to make an impact in the communities they serve. Save money, live better at Walmart at 705 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby and at walmart.com.
Here's what's happening in Cleveland, Gaston, and Lincoln counties. Brought to you by the What's Up Shopper and Big O Country, WOHS, WCSL, and WLON. Vietnam Veteran Remembrance Day will be held Saturday, May 2nd at 5 p.m. at the Howards Creek Veterans Center. If you or a loved one is a Vietnam veteran, you're asked to come and be honored for serving our country in the Vietnam War. It is free and open to the public, and all veterans are welcome. Sponsored by the Vietnam Veterans of Lincoln County. For more information, call 980-429-9555. And the Kings Mountain Little Theater presents Mary Poppins, May 1st, 2nd, 8th, and 9th at the Joy Performance Theater in Kings Mountain. Tickets are $10 each. To make a reservation, you can call 704-730-9408. And that's What's Up, brought to you by the What's Up Shopper and Big O Country, WOHS, 1390 AM, WCSL, 1590 AM, and WLON, 1050 AM. For more information, go to whatsupshopper.com.
Sports Talk, David Kieber, Terry Reinhart, Jason Barber, Kevin Hastings, Evan Smoke Ludwig on the board. Before we get back into it a little bit, we're going to check in with Calvin and Perk again over at Crossroad Ford. What's going on?
Hey, thank you there. We are at Crossroads Ford in Shelby, and we're getting ready for the first annual May Day Car Show. We're going to be here broadcasting live from 10 to 2. They're going to be here till 5 o'clock this afternoon, and all makes, all models, all welcome today, along with motorcycles as well.
Right beside of us. All you got to do is drop, and you can hear them crank up if you want them to, and they'll just, oh, they're just beautiful bikes. Friendly people out here to service you in every way that they can today.
Better believe it. These are the folks from the Guardians of the Children of Cleveland County. And do we have a spokesperson here that wants
I'll
to
find
talk?
One.
come here, gal. Come over here. Everybody's
mind,
pointing
you.
At everybody.
I'll
so, Perk's going to talk to this young lady.
Talk to her.
We're here from the Guardians of the Children, Cleveland County, and we're here to help educate the community on the prevention of child abuse.
That's always a good thing to do that. Everybody should take care of their children.
Yes, absolutely.
Well, y'all come on out and join us.
We'll be here all day.
Well, we're gonna have a partnership out here today with them, Calvin.
We're going to have a big old time. We got some Subway sandwiches coming.
On their way.
From Subway of Cherryville, Mr. Al Long helping us out there. So he'll be coming. So, Al won't be coming, but the sub sandwiches will be coming.
The madam will be bringing the sandwiches.
Yes,
maybe.
Yes. We'll have the sandwiches. Register to win. We got some goodies we're giving away.
Giving away some Fairground Speedway tickets out here to the Fairground and Racetrack. Going to give away 4 rounds of golf at the Deerbrook Golf Course. 4 tickets to the Hickory Crawdads, a $25 gift card to Newt's. Some of them famous What's Up t-shirts.
What's up?
And Subway sandwiches. You can get your taco tickets here. Register to win. You can pick up a What's Up shopper, get you a Subway, a cold drink, some tater chips, and enjoy the day with us.
And I believe, did they have some coffee and donuts up there?
I'll let you know.
Did I see?
Five minutes.
I know they got some coffee. I don't know about the donuts,
well,
but.
You don't drink coffee, so it don't
matter. Yeah, Diet Mountain Dew. I'll be all right.
Yes, you will. Calvin, they've got one of the largest inventories in Cleveland County, too. And like I said they can have any vehicle you want here within 3 hours. They got over 3,400 new vehicles available and 1,400 pre-owned cars out here.
That's right. Just check it out, crossroadsshelby.com, and you'll find them all. All right.
I'm seeing some Mustangs pulling in down here, too. Did you
yep.
notice those?
We got some Mustangs coming. So bring your cars and park it no matter what brand or what kind of car you have. Ford, Chevrolet, Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Edsel, it does not matter.
Just name it.
Just come on over and park and show. If it rolls, just come show it off today.
That's right.
All right, David, we'll send it back to you, Calvin and Perk at Crossroads Ford in Shelby.
Sounds good. Sounds like y'all having too good of a time over there at Crossroads Ford right now. Get over and check them out. See what's going on. Crossroads Ford in Shelby. Can't miss it. Dixon Boulevard and Post Road. So
it's time to get in your car and head that way because the sandwiches will be there about the time our show will end. Mm-hmm. You can listen to the car on the way over there.
Well, we've talked a little bit of NBA this morning, Major League Baseball. Terry, you probably want to talk some football.
How about them Cowboys?
Yeah, I mean.
All right, now as we go on to
now that's over.
Okay. Yeah.
That was good, Terry.
Well, I got all kind of remarks this past week of stuff I was sending out. All these
well,
things
deserve
all
you said,
for
you,
three,
you
three words or less.
With you the things about
you,
yeah,
you initiated this.
He said three words or less, which tells me most of them were 2 words.
I mean, I didn't know I had so many fans.
I'm at work, and I take a break. I step out from my cubicle, and I cut my phone on. And I see 5 missed text messages all coming from Terry Reinhart. Like, what in the world is this?
You thought we got Peterson, didn't you?
No.
That could happen. Don't be scared.
If the Cowboys get Peterson, our phones will not stop. That's a right. day.
Man, if the Cowboys get Peterson, I'm not going home, man. My brother.
Stephen A. said it's a wrap.
My
well,
brother.
I just don't see how they can. Ridiculous. I mean, they may do it, but I don't see how they can. Ooh. I mean.
But now, man, we got
well,
Collins for nothing.
Until 2030.
Yeah.
You might have to. I mean, but. The salary cap reasons.
Oh,
now
we're 12.
Would
we
come
got
into play,
we so. Made the exact enough room
yeah.
to make the trade. It. We got 12.6, and that's what he gets paid.
But how much did they? How
the
much?
Rookie,
how
the
much
rookies
they,
don't count on that.
Okay.
They got
okay.
they got their own
right.
salary.
Okay. That's what I was going with that. I was trying to figure out how much money would the rookies take up of that.
But, I mean, it was one of them things where we got Jones, and that was a good pick, a respectable young man coming to us.
That's the only one.
But then nobody wanted Gregory, so we said, okay, we'll go get him.
Well, you got him now. He'll next season, he'll be in the drug program. He's already on the radar for,
But then when Collins come up, Collins, he was every team wanted him. Yeah, all 32, he lowered it to 8. He said, this is the only people I'm going to play for.
It's a sad story.
Well, that it's a sad story, and that they didn't want to.
Right, he could be a perfectly fine kid.
But how do you blame one of the football teams for not playing?
Yeah, they didn't want to Aaron Hernandez because they've seen Robert Kraft testifying in a murder case.
It is amazing that nobody picked him in like the 5th, 6th, 7th round.
Teams with multiple 7th round picks. Why did this guy? If he works out fine, if he don't fine.
Once again, they don't want to see their owner on the witness stand of a murder trial.
But Jason, to that point, why did so many teams go after him afterwards? It's the same thing.
Because they got cleared. It come out he's not the father of the child. Yeah. It come out he basically didn't have motive for the murder of his ex-girlfriend. So once his name got cleared, then everybody, okay.
I still say if you got multiple 7th-round picks, you just go ahead and use one on him.
Exactly.
Because that second 7th-round pick you made, probably not going to be on your team anyway.
They don't make team anyway.
So if a team thought they could use help on the offensive line, take him in the 7th round. I mean, and there were probably 5 or 6 teams that had multiple 7th-round picks.
Now Dallas has, what, 4 first-round picks?
I'm telling
on the first round, if you count him as a first-round pick. So. But Jones said, the reason that they didn't draft quarterback is because McFadden. He loves McFadden. He's in love with him.
Right.
He's a Razorback. That's why.
Right.
And granted, McFadden and Maury have both had exactly 1,000 yard season, and everybody gets on about Murray, but he was always injured, Terry.
Same
thing as McFadden.
Well, I'm gonna be honest with you. Emmitt Smith even come out and said before, and I think we mentioned this last week, that McFadden and Randall. It's all the Cowboys need back there with that line
he'll
up
good
there.
If he's healthy. He'll be good if he's healthy. He really will. Now, speaking of health, I got to move to this. Talking about sad.
Yeah.
What about the Jacksonville Jaguars?
Oh.
Number 3 pick, Dante Fowler Jr.
That
first,
quick.
First practice
ACL
that
yesterday.
Quick. Sure did.
He never missed a game at Florida in 3 seasons. And then your first practice in the NFL, Terry ACL. And he hadn't signed his contract, but they did sign a thing, injury waiver, where the Jaguars have to negotiate in good faith, still with him. But. That's the risk. I bet other rookies that haven't signed contracts yet, like, hold up. Hold up. We're not going out there.
I'm not signing it. I'm not even jumping on the field until this is done.
We see this every year, though, guys. People go out, and they will go out from now. We'll be losing starters in the NFL.
Oh, it will.
From now till the season begins. Obviously, you lose some during the season, but you lose so many during the offseason that it's just unbelievable, and it just hits Jacksonville. Quick, they go out there and this guy could do it in a pickup basketball game. It could happen anywhere, but you just wonder some kind of curse or something on
and
those guys or what it might be.
And these guys, they take physical at the combine. It's the underwear Olympics. They prob and probe. You got all these physicals, these MRIs, X-rays, everything that they take. Teams want to check your health before they draft
none
you.
Of it, none
you know,
of it
nothing,
matters. Nothing
shows
predicts.
Up.
Yeah, there's no predicting of it. Yeah, so you never know. But you don't know when someone's going to get hurt like that. It's just a sad situation for Jacksonville.
Well, the draft last week went by, seemed like in a flash. It seemed like to me it's been longer, than a week ago now. It wound up last Saturday. It just, for some reason, it seems like it's been farther back than that. I thought if I myself had to pick a couple teams that I thought did real well, obviously Dallas did with their picks and even the undrafted signee that they got, but I also thought that the Jets did well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I want to mention one guy that Dallas picked up. The last guy, Swizzum, he's come from Texas, a tight end.
Yeah.
He didn't have but 10 catches all last year, but they picked him up on kind of he's a blocking back, a blocker. So, that's why they got him. And, I hope he works out, but that was a really strange pick for me, and that was late, So
just
I didn't understand that.
Just taking chances anyway. Yeah. Well, you need bodies for – practice. Damn, you don't want to wear Jason Witten now. He's getting old. He needs to be sitting in a sauna in a jacuzzi somewhere.
Hold on,
he's
same age as me. Hold on. But you talking about the Jets? Yeah, where they had drafted Leonard Williams there in the first round. They picked up a quarterback. They took Bryce Petty out of Baylor.
Didn't they get the receiver from Ohio State?
Yeah,
they got Devin Smith.
Right.
Yeah.
That's their
second problem
one,
is they don't have a quarterback.
Too. Right. And that's it. They may have the best defense
like I said,
in the NFL.
They drafted Bryce Petty, so we'll see.
I don't know if they'll be able to move the football.
I'm going to tell you, surprised Green Bay picked up in, I think, in the third round. Brett Hundley, quarterback. Fifth round, out of UCLA. No, just the backup. Think about
it. I was going to think, why are they drafting a quarterback?
But you think about the backups under, and come from Green Bay, even with Brett Favre. You know, Kurt Warner was a backup for Brett Favre.
Matt Hasselbeck.
Mark Brunell.
They wound up now, pretty good, didn't
now
they?
Now, under Aaron Rodgers, you had – no, Matt Flynn got paid. I mean, he had one good game. He got paid. He was living off
the and he's got a good teacher while he's there to show him. So.
Yes.
He might not teach him anything. Favre didn't teach him anything. Favre didn't need my job.
But what Green Bay does –
Don't want him taking my job either.
What Green Bay does, though, is McCarthy, they run a quarterback camp every offseason.
Yeah.
They bring all the quarterbacks in. They go through all drills and everything every year, no matter what.
Speaking of –
Yeah, but – well,
I'm
going to
change the subject.
Oh, yeah, but one thing about it, though, if you take it – if I'm a coming in and I'm a hunter – I can learn so much without him ever talking
that's
to
true.
Me.
And that's what Roger said. He sat and watched Favre.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He does not have to teach me anything. I can learn everything that he does. Just watch him, and I can come out okay.
You know, the Hundley's stock fell because he was great last year, not this past season, but the year before. If he came out then, he would have been really high in a draft, but then he didn't have as good a senior year, and his stock fell down a little bit.
I was just gonna say. Speaking of replacing somebody or replacements, how about the Panthers having Thomas Davis basically announce his future replacement in the NFL draft?
He's probably reading it like,
wait a minute, outside linebacker.
he should have changed it on the fly.
No, we're drafting should call down Gregory or Mateo or Leo Collins.
Yeah. Well, I think Carolina had a solid draft, not a good draft. The only pick I didn't agree with was taking another linebacker in the fifth round when he could have easily been taken as an undrafted free agent. But Shaq Thompson, the linebacker / safety / running back you were talking about, did have to leave with a hamstring-type injury yesterday, so that doesn't help. Funches apparently was really impressive. Devin Funches, really, he left with cramps, but he should be fine. I mean, he's a big athlete. I think that's why. But, you know, the draft picks look pretty good for Carolina. Darrell Williams was the last one off the field in practice trying to get reps at right tackle. Didn't allow a sack last year at Oklahoma, so that's a pretty good sign for Carolina for offensive line. And Cameron Artis Payne, who's already taken D'Angelo Williams' jersey, apparently is looking really bright from what a lot of people are saying. So Carolina, they always seem to, you know, media seems to downgrade their drafts, but the past few years they've really done a great job with their drafting.
Well, I think their strategy is, and it has been for 20 years, is just play good defense, run the ball, and
keep us in the game.
Stay in the game at the end, hope you can kick a field goal. Yep. I mean, that's been their offense.
And they've been successful doing it for 25
years.
You know, this is the one year. Every year there's a couple teams that the guys, when the draft's over, they get to hammer. There wasn't anybody out there to hammer this year. I mean, you know, maybe nobody did great, right? And you really don't know about a draft for 3 to 5 years. But nobody maybe did great, but – nobody did horrible, and there was a lot of, you know, just it's almost like chalk. I mean, they could tell who you were going to pick, and you picked them.
I think it's interesting to see the what's going to happen in Philadelphia with Kelly and all these people. Apparently, you know, none of the players apparently like him. He wants to be with Mariota. I mean, there's even reports he's trying to trade himself to Tennessee. I mean, it's interesting. I mean, the whole NFC East is just a disaster besides Dallas right now.
Well, everybody knew when he went in here that's what he was wanting, and then he did not get it.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what he had said. All these people coming here, I'm going to trade all these off. They're going to give up Mariota, and we're going to be fine. That's what I want. But it never happened. And now he's kind of set back, and people are looking at him like, okay, now what are we going to do? What are you going to do from here?
Jason, former players are bad-mouthing him, even using race comments.
I don't see the race thing, because you replace –
last time I looked, DeMarco Murray was an African-American.
You replace Shady McCoy with DeMarco Murray. You bring in Sam Bradford, who's a minority.
Yeah.
And Stephen A, he been on this kick, but the whole – I think he called Riley Cooper there. But if you want – I think the race shouldn't have been a factor. You want to say he got rid of players that were – that had attitudes or that had –
McCoy's showing a lot about his attitude right now, coming out and talking about all this
How could you even get to the level of an NFL coach or an NBA coach in today's society with many people that play? How could you be racist?
I don't think it's – I think it's more of a prejudice against players that have quote unquote swag.
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely,
quote unquote
absolutely,
swag. That's
absolutely.
What that is because.
And there's nothing wrong with that.
No.
If a coach don't feel like that fits his system.
Yeah,
you know
that's
mean?
Nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong right. with that. You know, because if as a.
You don't
Chip
think
Kelly,
Des Bryant would stay in Philadelphia too long?
No, no. It's because Chip Kelly, think about it. You a new guy coming in.
Yeah.
The people he got rid of was Andy Reid's
yes,
folks.
Ma'am. He wants yes, ma'am.
He's
too.
Getting rid of Andy
right.
Reid's Andy Reid stuff. He's one of his Reed. Own guys and guys that he know that can fit his system. And he feel like with Shady McCoy, you're replaceable. I mean,
yeah.
think about
I
it.
I actually think Dez might fit in better than McCoy because Dez is a team first guy. He wants to win. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
I mean,
he's still got the.
He is about himself, and he likes to show off a little
bit. Oh, yeah,
bit,
but he's a wide receiver. That's just wide receivers,
right.
period.
And speaking of draft, kind of put it more in a positive ending on this.
How you know we're ending?
I don't know.
Are you going to talk about the Browns or
no,
something?
No, no, no. It's really positive. A former Green Beret, Nate
oh,
Boyer,
yeah.
the 34-year-old long snapper, is an undrafted free agent for the Seahawks. You know, just a great story and, you know, makes you feel proud. He worked his way through Texas and everything. He started long snapping while in Afghanistan, just started doing it to work on it. It's a
hope
very,
he makes the team.
I hope you know? He does too. Yes.
Yeah, I think everybody likes to see somebody like that make the team. And
speaking of Seattle,
because of lack of work.
They're catching some heat this week. One of the players they drafted was kicked out of school at Michigan for domestic violence.
Yeah.
And, you know, the GM come out talking about, well, we did our due diligence and did our investigation.
That's why you don't draft Lael Collins.
He's on a trade block to Dallas.
No, they never, but however, they told me they did an investigation. They only talked to the player they drafted. They never talked to the victim involved or got police reports or anything like that. So now that's what's coming out. So Seattle's trying to catch some heat about that.
Who knows about that?
Well, I'm not going to defend your Cowboys at all. You know that, Terry. But I will say this. With as many players as they are that come out, there's going to be stuff you don't know.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Right.
You know what
oh,
I mean? Yeah. I mean, there's going to be stuff that you don't know. I mean, how many – we're talking about each team right now has probably got 90 people out there, you know, 2,700. You know, I mean, you're not going to know everything about everybody.
And there's a great article that Rashard Mendenhall wrote in the Huffington Post, former Pittsburgh Steeler. He wrote the NFL in 10 years. He hoped that people can take and separate that when a player messes up, that it's not the league's fault. The league cannot govern thousands of players all at the same time. But players, you have to separate the fact, hey, if this player messed up, that's on this person. It's not the NFL's fault because this person did that, you know. That was one of the things that he hoped to see in the future. Whereas, you know, separated with if someone gets, you know, politicians gets in trouble. It's not the whole government's fault that this politician
right,
got in trouble. It's that individual. So that's why, you know, he's hoping that people can start separating the fact that because John Smith over here want to act the fool, it's not the Seattle Seahawks' fault because John Smith act the fool.
Right.
Yeah, you're saying if Tom Brady wants to cheat, Belichick had nothing to do with it.
Hey.
You see there, Terry?
Yeah.
I got to say this, too, and you guys help me remember some names, okay? One stands out to me. We love to talk about our North Carolina high school athletes, Todd Gurley.
Yep.
Obviously the highest one taken this year, the 10th pick
Man,
overall.
That made me so
goes
mad.
Goes to the Rams. What a player.
Best
high school
player
I've seen.
He just has to stay healthy.
For the last 6 months, every mock draft has said Gurley and Gordon – 27, 28 in Panthers and Cowboys range.
And Jeff Fisher's going
2 days before the freaking draft.
That's what you think.
Oh, Gurley's going to be top 10 now. What? Everybody started texting me.
They said, and San Diego says we're moving up to get Gordon.
A lot of teams had him ranked third
on
their board as overall player.
Had he not got hurt?
Yeah.
Also got to mention Jamison Crowder.
He's
Jamison Crowder, a Union County.
Well,
I can't remember which high school, but Jamison Crowder's a Monroe
before
or
that
one
in
the
first
in
round
Union County.
Right before Carolina was on the clock, former Mallard Creek standout DJ Humphreys was
taken. That's right.
So that another Carolina guy, and I know former Western Carolina safety Ace Clark is the first Western Carolina player to make it in the NFL in some sort of way since Brad Hoover. He got taken as an undrafted free agent by the Seattle Seahawks. So
and you know what? You mentioned undrafted Gardner Webb kid, right? And I'm going to tell you something right now. C.J. Wilson's a prime example about you don't have to be drafted to make a team.
Right.
Because C.J. has now made two different teams.
Yeah, he's with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Right. Played the final four games last year on the active roster.
Well, the way the draft is, the way I see it, the first three rounds are your players that, you know, they're going to make
the
roster. They're going to make the roster they're going to play. Fourth round through everyone else in the country is the same.
It's
what fits your system.
Mm-hmm.
It should be personally. If you fit a system, if you fit a team, if you fit a city, it's all.
What's funny, Kevin,
is all these kids,
like CJ, I've talked to him about this process before.
Yeah,
he was contacted and by five or six teams that said,
If you're not drafted, we're calling you.
Yeah,
yeah. It's basically better to be undrafted at
and they
that
call
point
instantly.
If you're not in the top three or four, yeah,
pick or choose.
Yeah, because you won't be. You'll probably get paid more as an undrafted free agent. And I've talked to people like that who've played in the NFL, and they've said that same thing too. It's better if you get undrafted in the late rounds.
Yep, because then you have your pick.
Right.
Pick of games.
You can see what the best offer is. And
if you want to be a Cowboy, you can be a Cowboy. Ain't that right, Terry?
That's exactly right.
Terry's so pumped about this.
But I think it's great, man.
But Terry, you take last year's team, you improve your line. It's going to be better.
The line, we even deeper in the line.
Then that's what you added was depth. Because the line was solid anyway. So
then on defense, you had Randy Gregory.
Yep.
You add
Hardy.
Hardy in game 11
woman beater,
against the Panthers. And then you add the safety. So you've improved everywhere in all your skill positions. You didn't lose anybody, but Murray from McFadden, that's going
to
be the biggest
question. Reading a little bit here. They're high on McFadden. Now, they might just be saying that to be positive about everything, but it seems like they're pretty high on
McFadden.
But
now, don't forget, Johnson's already come out and said, I'd play in Dallas.
We might have Chris Johnson.
He'd
make a good kick returner.
Well, I think you guys are forgetting one thing about Dallas. They're getting back Sean Lee after tearing his ACL.
I mean, every position. We've almost improved every position that we needed to.
Well, one thing, y'all franchise Dez, and then I seen the tweet yesterday that said y'all gonna think about making Dez a punt returner.
What? Yeah, it's stupid.
Y'all gonna what?
It's
they must be mad at him. If you're gonna do that. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back with more sports talk in a moment.
The new cart paths are finished at Kings Mountain Country Club. Come on over and ride and play. Right now you can play and ride Monday through Friday for $27. Seniors 55 and older can ride and play Monday through Friday for $22. Ride and play weekends for $35. Make your tee time today by calling 704-739-5871. Enjoy the brand new cart paths, and the course is in great shape at the Kings Mountain Country Club. 109 Country Club Drive in Kings Mountain. Call again at 704-739-5871 for your tee time.
Our homes are as precious for the memories they hold as for the things inside. But nearly half of American homes don't have working smoke detectors. That's not good. And that's why right now, your local Allstate agent will give you a free smoke detector battery just for stopping by, whether you're a customer or not. It's one more way they help keep you protected every day.
See Damon Scott, your local Allstate agent at the McDaniel Scott Agency, 404 Cherryville Road in Shelby. Call 704-484-3463.
Humans, gather round. Today is a new day with kids to inspire, rules to bend, jokes to tell, smiles to crack, songs to sing, and before all of that, rich, smooth McCafé coffee to love. Because starting your day with a little lovin' is always the right choice.
The best things begin with the little things. Love every day to the fullest with a hot or iced McCafé coffee, starting at only $1. McDonald's, the official coffee of the Charlotte Hornets. Prices and participation may vary, a la carte only.
Over here with it. Easy there.
Great. Rates are low today. The time is right to improve your home. We have home improvement loans and we're lending right now. Join your neighbors and friends and people all over our local communities who are improving the quality of their lives by improving the quality of their homes. We're an equal housing lender. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community minded just like you.
This Sunday, May 10th, is Mother's Day. Take Mom to the Captain's Cap on Linwood Road in Gastonia and make it a family tradition. Check out their Mother's Day special. Steak and fried green shrimp for only $13.95. And the Captain's Cap on Linwood Road in Gastonia will be open for Mother's Day. The Captain's Cap Family Fish House, voted 2014's Best Seafood Award winner for Gaston and Cleveland counties.
Springtime means green time in your yard, so check out the selection of Echo Lawn and Garden equipment at Shelby Hardware. And now at Shelby Hardware, the Echo SRM225 straight shaft trimmer is just $199.99 after a $20 in-store instant rebate. And the Echo GT225 curved shaft trimmer is only $149.99 after a $20 in-store instant rebate. Shelby Hardware, your Echo dealer. 506 South Lafayette Street, Shelby.
Pick up this week's What's Up Shopper for some great diamond buys from Arnold's Jewelry and Uptown Shelby. See the Affinity Collection, a 3/4 carat total weight diamond ring for only $16.99. And for that beautiful bride, Arnold's Jewelry at Uptown Shelby has a 1 3/8 carat total weight diamond ring for only $33.95. For any occasion, see Arnold's Jewelry, 226 South Washington Street at Uptown Shelby, online at arnoldsjewelry.com. Considering hardwood flooring for your home? Then head to Flooring America in Kings Mountain or Carpet One Interiors in Ranlo. Right now at both locations, you'll find a big selection of in-stock hardwoods on sale, priced as low as $2.99 a square foot. That's right, only $2.99 a square foot. At Flooring America, 602 Slater Street in Kings Mountain, and Carpet One Interiors in Ranlo.
It's time. Time to head to the Pine Mountain Golf Course. Pine Mountain invites all former Pine Grove Golf Course players to come on up. You'll find a challenging 18-hole par 68 course. Play all day on weekends for only $22. Seniors can play and ride on weekends for $19. And ask about the Clip and Save coupons available. Call 828-433-4950 for your tee time at the Pine Mountain Golf Course, located at the base of the beautiful South Mountain State Park.
And welcome back to Sports Talk. David, Terry, Kevin, Jason, Evan with you on a Saturday morning. Glad to have you with us. Going to check in with Calvin and Perk once again over at Crossroads Ford in Shelby.
Good morning.
Yeah,
to you.
Good morning to everybody out here. Richard, you want to talk on the radio? Come over here. We got Richard Michaels.
We got
He's
the man
general
in
manager.
Charge.
Good morning.
Good morning. How's everybody doing?
Hey, we having a fine time. Richard, you put this car show, motorcycle show together, and, hey, looking for a pretty day here.
Absolutely. We just want people to stop out, see who we are, have some fun, and come meet everybody.
Yep, we're going to have some free Subway sandwiches here in a little while.
Beautiful, beautiful. Can't wait.
Hey, tell us what's in the back of that truck. I see you've been giving some goodie bags to some folks today.
Oh, absolutely. We've got hats. We've got license plate frames, pins. That goodie bag, you can use it over and over again. It's environmental friendly. So come on down, pick up one, meet everybody, and have some fun.
All right, Rich, appreciate you coming by and saying hello to us.
Yes, sir. Thank you for having us.
Oh, yes.
He could have picked a prettier day to have this, Kevin.
I know. I don't know. It's such an ugly day today. I tell you, rainy, wet.
People just don't know how to plan for a big organization or a group thing, do they?
Come on out. It's the first annual May Day Car Show. We want you to come out and be a part of it here with us today. We'll be here till 2 o'clock. They'll be here till 5 o'clock. And coming out and check out the cars here. Clarence Jones is here with his Mustang. Miss Amy, she's got her. What do you got? You got coffee and donuts this morning.
Yes, she does. And now, you know, we've got the guardian for the children over here on the motorcycle.
Right.
Need to come out and visit with them, let them do some talking to you and tell you what all they do, you know, for the county around here. It's just a good organization to be
it
involved
is.
In.
And some of them are out riding the roads right now.
Yes, they are. We've seen them leave, about 10 of them leave a few minutes ago.
Hey, come on out and see us. Like we said, we'll be here till 2 o'clock. Free food, fun, and prizes here today. Crossroads Ford.
To give away today, Calvin.
First annual May Day Car Show.
That's right. Us.
Mr. Kiever, we're going to send it back to you at the studios. Calvin and Burke, Crossroads Ford in Shelbytown.
All right. Thank you, Calvin. Perk, we'll check back in with those guys in just a little bit. Tyler Sane lets me know he slept late this morning. he gives me a word back. Tyler, we told everybody you won the conference back-to-back. You won the tournament back-to-back.
That's always said.
In spite of the coach.
That's right.
Now, congratulations, Tyler. Another good season. Good season for Lady Rebel
Softball. The girls told us he was just the bus driver.
Is that right?
Yeah, he takes us to the games. That's all he does.
Well, doing a good job of it. And he's taking care of his duties because he's getting them where they need to be. And they're winning games. Three shutouts. How about that? Three shutouts in the conference championship tournament.
You know, they did play Alexander Central this year in a game, you know. And people wonder how good the programs are. Well, you're playing Alexander Central. I mean,
state
champions. Yeah.
State champions. Top program.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. Right. One of the top 10 in the country.
Yeah, top 5 in
the nation. 5 now?
Yeah. So. Yeah, they've been there for a while. Mm. Almost at I think they're around 90-game win streak.
If you want to see a girls' softball complex, right up there and check that one out.
Yeah. It's amazing.
It is.
It looks like robots playing softball. That's how good they are.
Yeah, they are
Yeah. And I hear the coach, the longtime coach, Monty Sherrill, I've heard he's headed to Pfeiffer. So, maybe taking a couple players with him. Yeah, so, look out for that Pfeiffer softball program to be top-notch.
But like I said, that's the reason I've given Tyler and them a lot of credit, because they put somebody like that on their schedule just to kind of justify where we're at compared to the top
teams. Poor mouth in the first year. We're not very good. We can't hit. We're not good. And, you know, here they win the conference again, win the tournament, don't give up
a run. Great job.
Yeah. I know what he's doing when he's giving me that poor mouthing like that. also, last night, we got to mention the Bunker Hill boys win the conference tournament championship in SD7, beating East Lincoln by a score of 5-3. The Burns Bulldogs, earlier in the week, won the SMAC conference championship by a score of 8-3 in 15 innings, a big, long marathon type of game. How many innings, from what point was it 3-3?
From the sixth to the top of the 15th.
Okay. So just nine innings.
They didn't do nothing. They didn't score the first like four or five innings, and then they scored both scored three. Okay. And then
the game started at what time?
10 innings. It was a 4.5 hour game.
I think it started about 6:50 or something.
Oh, we did start early.
Yeah, they knew what was going to happen. It was getting a head start on it. Knew what was going to happen.
Those are the same umpires that did the first. No. They did two games that week, and the second one about went into extra innings too. We were joking about that.
I don't want to put anybody on the spot, but I'm gonna ask this question: who were the girls' conference champions
in
the SMAC, the softball champions?
I can find that out real quick.
Want to give them some
Lincoln
credit
Charter
too.
Beat Cheryl Ironman for the 1A.
Right, Lincoln Charter won that, and then and the boys baseball it was just the opposite. Mm-hmm. The Cheryl boys won the conference tournament, defeating Lincoln Charter. But yeah, I was just trying to figure out who that SMAC champion was in girls softball as well. We do know this: yesterday in a big game, a play-in game, basically Bessemer City girls beat Highland Tech. Was that 6-5?
Sure was
6-5. Richard Walker, I mentioned to Kevin and Rick last night. Richard Walker confined. Game. Tyler says Crest was the conference champ. I think. Oh, now comes I think. he waits till I say it. And then he says I think.
The best way to find that out is follow Nelson Royster on Twitter.
There you go.
WHS fan of the year.
You just have to go through a lot of tweets to run it down, though, right? You have to go through quite a few tweets to run it down. But congratulations to those teams. Can't wait to see how those brackets come out today, seated just like football and basketball. You know, going 1 through 32. And, you know, West Lincoln, I know I talked with Coach Chapman a couple times yesterday, and he's got a 33% chance of having a home game in the first round because three teams are tied at 16. And if he gets that 16, he'll be at home against the 17. So I know he's hoping and would like to get that home playoff game. Obviously, Bunker Hill, East Lincoln will open theirs at home. Burns, Crest, both of those guys most likely going to open at home. I know Burns will. And also, I got to think East Rutherford will open the playoffs at home. Cheryl obviously will in baseball as well. Cheryl's going as a
one should
be seed.
Wednesday.
And what was their – what did their overall record wind up?
They were 20-3.
They had a tremendous
season. And then
they
got beat the other night. It's a 20-4.
They got beat by East Rutherford, Crest, and was Burns the third one? Not 100% sure.
And if they go on a 20-game schedule, I don't know if that's what they do or not, but they will be able to drop all those you just named.
Yeah, they didn't lose a conference game at all, went undefeated throughout the whole year.
Yeah, then they lost. They didn't lose. That was somebody else. I don't know. Who did they lose? They lost East Rutherford.
And that's what I was going to say. They also played good competition. They played Crest a couple times, right? East Rutherford. So they played some good out-of-conference competition, too, which will help them. I think Cheryl can make a deep run. I think Burns can make a deep run in the playoffs as well.
And now it just depends on pitching depth. You know, you can win that one game. Everybody's got their ace.
Oh, yes.
Do you win your ace game against the other ace?
And here's the problem, too. You don't know what in the first round even. You might run into a guy that's a team that's won eight games.
And he's got one guy's got 95. Yes. Yeah, it doesn't
matter. That guy's beating them. You're right. You know, I mean, that's the funny thing about the baseball playoffs. Talk a little bit the other week about the scheduling, and I talked with Smoke a little bit, you know, and was talking about scheduling. The way to avoid a situation like that is if you do what that conference did and play the same team twice in a week, you're not going to face the same pitcher twice, mm-hmm. you know, which is good. I like that. I like the reasoning behind that. And that way one pitcher can't determine who wins the regular season conference title by playing the same, you know, when you play that second best team in your league and you're able to use your ace both times, chances are you're going to win.
So, Trevor was upset in the first round of the Easter tournament.
They sure were. North Gaston. They sure were. And then I think they bounced back and won their next
two. They won the next two, yeah. They did.
They beat consolation games.
They beat Stuart Kramer 9-3 and Bessemer City 10-0 in the two consolation games.
And I can't remember. Did South Point win that tournament? South Point. That's another team we haven't mentioned.
I think it was Ashbrook that won in extra innings, 13 innings, I believe.
South Point we hadn't talked about, and they're likely to have a first-round draft pick in the Major League Draft coming up in June. The Davila kid could go in the first round.
Wow.
He's that type of pitcher.
I did not know that.
Yeah, he is. He's amazing.
I think Hunter Harvey was the last pitcher to go in the first round from this area, and that wasn't that long ago. It was about 2 years ago.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Bumgarner before
his
that.
His brother beat my team in the playoffs.
Chris.
2-1.
Chris, the Harvey family's produced some, mm-hmm. some
yes,
pretty good arms.
While we're speaking baseball schedules, David, Richard Walker just tweeted out the American Legion baseball schedules.
I do have them down the hall. Let me get around there and grab something to talk about up.
I don't have Shelby's. I do have.
Here on the thing, basically, Trevor Post 100 will get kicked off Memorial Day weekend, May 23rd at Henderson County, 24th at Burke, and the 25th at Alexander County, and the 27th at Gastonia. So their first four games are all on the road.
Yes, they are. Real quick before we get into the Legion schedules, which we do want to run down, Milton Baker sends me that confirms Cherville's 22-3. Their losses were in the to North Gaston, East Rutherford, and Crest. So, you know, a 2A team and two 3As were Cherville's only losses on the season. Tyler tells me that the NCHSAA told him yesterday that the brackets probably won't be out till Monday.
Wow.
So, you know, you find out on Monday, and some teams are wanting to play on Tuesday.
Somebody had a vacation this weekend, and they couldn't
get it all together. These schedules will be posted when I get back.
I'm going to the beach.
And he was theoretically told, now I'm already impressed that Tyler used the word theoretically.
Mm, that's not even a big word Wednesday.
He was told that two teams from the same conference now can play for a state championship, that one may go east and one may go west, and they could actually play for a state championship when it's
what?
All said and done. Yep.
Wow.
So what do they do? Is it a tournament once they get there?
I think so.
Okay, that's what they mean. Okay, he don't mean that they're going to put a team in the eastern bracket, I would imagine.
He also told me something else, but I'll leave that to the imagination.
They're not going to put West, but he's not saying they're going to put West Lincoln in the east.
It comes down to them three words or less.
I don't know. I think that was meant for Terry. To be honest with you.
Is that a round robin type thing where you get four teams in there and then they play each other?
Well, they used to have a four team, but they'd still do a double elimination.
Okay.
One would play four, two play three, and then it'd be like a little double elimination bracket. So,
well, good. I do have the Cherville Post 100 schedule. I couldn't find the Shelby.
Yeah, Jason, we already discussed just the fact that – go ahead and go through it. Just the fact they opened with four straight road games.
Well, five out of six road games, too. The only home one will be against Kings Mountain on Friday, May 29th. As far as our broadcast schedules go, during the regular season, we do one game a week. It's not necessarily Friday or Tuesday. It's usually the best game for us, what matches up with our Atlanta Braves schedule. And we try to get the best matchups for you guys. So we'll be doing one game a week on WLON 1050 AM, WCSL 1590 AM, and WOHS 1390 AM, the Cleveland, Lincoln, and Cherville game of the week. Cherville, looking at the schedule, the one I'm looking forward to, and we'll do that game live video as long as they'll let us, Monday, June 22nd at UNCC versus Wilmington. Mm-hmm. So
and we don't know what time that game may be.
Yeah,
that's
we don't know what
time. A Monday, and it could be a noon, a 4 o'clock, because there are going to be more than two teams there at that event.
So we're gonna try our best to do that game. We'll definitely have it on radio. We should try to have that on video too. But looking at – and the biggest thing in the schedules this year, of course – no Shelby and Cherville against each other, guys, for the first time, and who knows how long. I'm sure that they've got it in the paper somewhere since the last time.
I think your dad's got us that first week of Legion season with Lincoln County, Cherville, Shelby. I think we're a little heavy that week, carrying some games because the Braves are on the West Coast.
Now, that is true as far as the now what's good for Shelby and the Lincoln County guys. Now, y'all get to come over and visit the Shelby facilities now. Since they're in those conference now, Shelby's joined the East. I think that's one of the main reasons why they did that was to let those Area 4 teams play over there. I guess. I mean, Maybe you could have redid the schedules a little bit to
did
allow.
Did not know that, but that kind of I like it for that. If that's for the reason, I like it. I like it. Give them a chance to play at that nice ballpark. Because
that gets all those Gastonia teams that ain't in their conference, or one of them, I think. Go ahead, Chase.
Let me say, speaking of Lincoln County, they'll kick off their season next Sunday, the 17th, at Caldwell. Caldwell County at 5 p.m. It's a doubleheader. And then they'll play Lincoln County, yep. Then on the 23rd, at the Gaston Braves. And then on the 24th, they play home to Shelby on May 24th.
Okay.
And then just start off their season. And then Shelby posts 82. They'll open up at home on the 23rd, May 23rd, against Union County, at Lincoln County on the 24th, at home against Mint Hill on the 30th. That's a 5 p.m. doubleheader.
Yep. The main thing for everybody is keep your whiteout handy
early
part of the season schedule.
The schedules will change.
If teams are still playing that involve players
rain,
or coaches.
If it's high school, yep. If it's vacations, sometimes coaches might want to go watch another team play and a game will cancel. You just don't know.
Especially that first 2 weeks could really change.
So just follow us
lot.
On KTC Broadcasting, our schedules online, on Facebook, on Twitter. We'll keep you updated with those schedules as they come. And one other thing I was going to talk about as far as Lincoln County, you know, you guys will be going over to Shelby and all those other schools. I think it is good for those to get to play. It is just weird that they couldn't find, like, one date in here to put Cherville and Shelby, you know, a home and away.
I don't get it. I don't like it either. I mean,
those
two rivals should play each other,
mm-hmm.
you know, twice a season.
Now, what that will do, it could set up a possible first-round matchup between them because, remember now, they play opposite each other.
But you got to think both those will finish high enough in the
division. It probably won't happen, never will happen. But that could also put – you know, back in the old days, it used to mean Cherville Shelby, if they did meet, would be in the championship game. So
yeah, area finals, if you can get that far.
Yep.
You're looking at that Cherville schedule, though. You know, you said the first four are away. It's seven out of the first ten are
seven
away.
Out of the first nine, yeah.
And y'all get your calculators out of.
We're going to keep going.
And got seven right. Speaking of the, you know, what the way the Braves schedule is, I got the schedule for the Braves this weekend as today they'll be playing at Washington at 3:50 p.m. All these games are going to be on all three stations. Pfister will be pitching for the Nationals. And then tomorrow Zimmerman will be pitching for the Nationals along with Wood pitching for the Braves, as that game will be at 1:20 p.m., so early starting time. And then Monday they'll play at Cincinnati at 7 o'clock, and that game will be on ESPN if you're at home. So that's the upcoming.
You'll be on ESPN if you're not at home.
Yeah.
Just real quick, Tyler, give me some information on how the regionals and finals are done now. You're talking about the double elimination tournament or the round robin type. Not anymore. They do it like baseball. Regional finals are 2 out of 3. State finals are 2 out of 3, just like baseball. They have 2 at UNCG and 2 at NC State. So, and I asked him if he liked that better, and he had some. He had some words for Walnut Creek. Sure. He didn't like Walnut Creek where they used to have that. We actually covered North Lincoln there. Mike Powell and myself did North Lincoln in the state championship. Their girls softball team, they were there 1 year. And I can remember one thing. Hot. Oh, it was
that
hot.
That time of the year.
It was hot. We had a tent, and it helped some. But, boy, it was a scorcher for those championships.
Speaking of rules changes this week, you know, association changes, football. Practices only can limit hitting, full live contact hitting, to 60 minutes for the week.
A week, yeah,
for a week.
60 minutes a week.
How do you count that though? Like, is there somebody? Do you have one guy with a stopwatch that writes that
There's
down
no
every
way.
Day?
There's no way.
I mean, but I've seen one
do you
coach
count contact Jason as.
No,
No.
They talking about full live contact. No, the thudding, if you do shoulder pads, helmets, and shorts, thudding, there's no limits on it.
No, but what I'm saying is that
I bet teams don't do it a full hour a week anyway.
But what I'm saying, how do you count it as far as like. Do you say, all right, from 3 to 4, everybody just run into each other and hit each other for an hour? Or do you go, well, that was 1 second. Y'all hit for one second.
That's the way
I
count
it. Wouldn't you count it? I mean, how do you count that? How do you even count it?
Yep, just like you were talking about last night, how the amount of action compares.
Yeah.
And then actual action.
So. Basketball, when you get to the regional semis and the regional finals, now the semifinals will not be at a neutral court site. It'll be at the higher seed, and only the regional finals will be at neutral court.
Really?
So only one game in the
regional. And I think that's the best thing they did right there. I think it needs to be at a home court. That's just me.
Well, I see advantage. Yeah, I see advantages for both. I mean, you know, the other sports do it. Mm-hmm. The other sports do it. They play it. You know, they play on their home field. So, if you're a higher seed, I guess you deserve to get that opportunity to play your regional
semifinal
game at home. So, and of course, where are they going? Still back to Greensboro to play?
They didn't announce sites, but they're trying to get games. More likely.
So there won't be that long travel on the Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday night. No, just basically Saturday. Just the Saturday championship. Mm-hmm. If they hold them on Saturdays, and I got to think they will, so they can do them all in one day. I hope they do. Anyway, yeah. I hope they do them all in one day.
Don't speculate. with every committee, they get in a room and they pick the worst idea. Yeah.
Don't try to tell. You know what will probably happen? Football type. One Friday night, three on Saturday.
Yeah, probably. So, and then the other
overnight lodging in.
Other rule changes brought up about teams playing in postseason tournaments like Myers Park girls wanted to. They're going to take it. They're going to take it to another committee to have it looked into right now. So there's no ruling on that yet.
When is that event? Is it already taking place?
Here's my thing. What's their argument for saying no? The kids can't play.
I don't know why they. I don't know why.
Well, I think you can limit
people with power.
They
reasons.
Have an argument.
I think they can limit though.
Maybe because they're not making money on it. That's something I think. This is a national tournament.
It's not these public schools' job to make money either. So,
but when they're trying to cash out,
I know that's not it's not their job to make money. But that doesn't mean that's what they don't think their job is. I mean, a lot of these.
Somebody actually told me a reason one time why they didn't want teams doing that, and I for some reason it slips my mind. I don't remember. It made a little bit of sense. It really did, but I don't remember now what it was.
But don't they not let North Carolina schools compete in these national tournaments or national
anything? They don't want them on, like, ESPN, like the national the television spotlight.
So they ask,
is it so much that, or is it the amount of games they're allowed to play a year and they've already played their match?
I think that was it.
But I think it had to do with the amount of games
they played. Yeah, that rule in the is what he's talking about.
So that's the case. Some teams, if you know you want to play this tournament, you cut back some of your regular season games. Although that hurts you.
But then they don't know they're getting invited until that schedule's out and most of it's already played.
And also you're hurting your own self when you know admissions and all that stuff. If you cut some games,
all you gotta do is write at the bottom of that rule limit in basketball. What is it? 23 regular season games, 20 and 3 tournament games.
No, but they keep upping that every year, no matter what.
Unless you're invited to a national tournament.
Yeah. Why can't you just play as many as you want? Why does there have to be rules? Like, why can't you just play? I can't take my team and play basketball.
I mean, we used to have football. Football used to only be 10. Then it went to 11. Now it's up to 12.
Advantage, they get to play 30 games. Oh, and there's something else.
But those same kids are going to go play summer ball somewhere. They're going to go play travel ball with the other.
Most of them on the same team.
It's better to have them, in control of adults. Yeah. Adults, quit making decisions that are awful for these kids.
And that's something else I want to talk about. 42 bowl games this year, y'all. We are starting to get ridiculous. We are going to have teams in some of these tournaments that have a losing record.
All you got to do in college, you win one game, then you make your bowl.
Next thing you know, it's going to be 100. Everyone's going
to
be in a bowl game.
You know and I know they got to find a way to get NC State in a bowl game. Boom, baby!
We probably got the third best winning percentage in the ACC when we arrive.
Glad to have you with us this morning. We've enjoyed it. For Kevin, Terry, Jason, Smoke, I'm David Kiever. We'll see you next week on Sports Talk. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay.
The money you save in your savings accounts earns interest, so it just makes sense to have your checking account also earn interest for you. A money market checking account pays interest and also offers the flexibility of writing checks. Certain fees may apply. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded just like you.
I'm Calvin Hastings, and I want to invite you to join me along with Big O Country as we broadcast live this Saturday, May 9th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. for the first annual May Day Car Show at Crossroads Ford in Shelby. The show will run all day Saturday, 10 to 5, and if you have an antique car or a show car, you're invited to bring it on by. All makes and models will be welcome for this very special event. Prizes will be awarded, and there will be no entry fee. And we'll be there from 10 to 2 with free Subway sandwiches from Subway of Cherryville. Also register to win some door prizes from Crossroads Ford. Plus our prizes, including a $25 gift card to Nukes. Free golf, including cart and green fee at the Deerbrook Golf Course. Hickory Crawdad baseball tickets. Cleveland County Fairground Speedway racing tickets. And What's Up Shopper t-shirts. So plan now to join us this Saturday, May 9th for the first annual May Day Car Show at Crossroads Ford in Shelby. 1775 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. It's time to start those projects you've been putting off, and the place to start is Cleveland Lumber Company in Shelby. Brighten up your home with a new coat of Benjamin Moore paint. you'll find every color under the sun, along with all of your painting supplies. Build a deck for those summer cookouts, fix that leaky faucet in the bathroom, or put in those new windows you've been wanting. Whatever the project, see Cleveland Lumber Company, 217 Arrowwood Street in Shelby. The project start and end with Lumber Company in Shelby. The strawberries are in at Spake Strawberries in Shelby. Big, red, luscious, juicy, sweet strawberries. Pick them yourself or buy these delicious strawberries already picked. Great for ice cream, pies, on cake, or just to eat by themselves. Big, red, juicy, sweet strawberries. Now at Spake Strawberries, Highway 150 East, between Highway 180 and 74 Business in Shelby. Or call 704-487-9933 for Spake Strawberries. Do you have a lot of old medications piled up? Well, most people do. Then get rid of them and do it safely. Drop off your old medications at the new medication drop box located inside Falston Pharmacy in Falston. All medications will be disposed of by the Cleveland County Sheriff's Department. It's easy. Just clean out your medicine cabinet, bring them in the Falston Pharmacy, and drop them in the box. Falston Pharmacy, Highway 18 north of Falston. For exquisite portraits that you'll treasure for a lifetime, see the professionals at the Victorian Rose Photography Studio in Uptown Shelby. Whether black and white or color, the Victorian Rose Studio specializes in senior portraits, bridal and wedding portraits, child and newborn portraits, oil portraits, and commercial portraits. The Victorian Rose features a video preview system. You see the poses immediately. The Victorian Rose Studio, 108 West Warren Street in Uptown Shelby.
We'd like to know, when's the best time to listen?
24/7.
All day.
That's the correct answer.
Big O Country, WHS Shelby.